Now, funny how? I mean, funny like I'm a clown, I abuse you.
You're dying, dying.
Well, the lunchtime whistle and the morning's finally done. I'm jumping in my car, I'm gonna have a little fun. The doghouse network's on my radio dial. Big dog's taking care of business for a while. If you're listening to another station, I don't understand. Nobody does it like Thom Abraham.
Give us a call, Steve.
He's a northern bred, southern fed, slick talking guy. Listeners in his posse are the junkyard dogs. The SEC from Tennessee to calling them hogs. From Gainesville up to Lexington to the Tide and Tiger Land. Nobody does it like Thom Abraham.
I guess I'm on here. Am I on? Can somebody respond?
Everyone, and welcome to Reaction Monday in the Doghouse. I am your host, Thom Abraham. Good to be back in the saddle. You know, missed the day last week on Wednesday with my travel to, did I miss Tuesday too? I missed Wednesday. I guess I missed Wednesday. Missed Wednesday last week with my travel to Tulsa, Oklahoma for the Bass Pro Shops Bassmaster Open and my coverage there of that. And then, of course, we were bounced by the NCAA tournament in all its glory. There's nothing like listening to the NCAA tournament in the afternoon on the radio. Absolutely phenomenal stuff. But it is Reaction Monday here in the Doghouse. And, man, do we have plenty to react to coming off the first two rounds of the madness. Plus, the NFL owners' meetings are underway with plenty of news coming out there. Deion Sanders is running his mouth again about next year's draft. We might get to that. Might not get to it. Plus, later this week, the 2024 Major League Baseball season opens. And as usual, they are totally tone deaf. I mean, sure, why not open on the day that the Sweet 16 begins? Because you can't wait till next Monday when you'll have the entire week to yourself. Since the Final Four doesn't begin until Saturday. I mean, how tone deaf can baseball be? Are you telling me that you couldn't wait just a little bit, just through the weekend? You're going to start the same day as the Sweet 16, and nobody is going to be talking about you. Not only that, whatever happened to the games being on ESPN all day long on opening day? Starting at 12 o'clock and having baseball all day long on opening day. There's one game on Thursday. One game on ESPN Thursday night. We're not watching that. Watching Alabama and North Carolina, as is the rest of the country. We're not going to watch a Texas Ranger baseball game. What are you doing? What are you doing, baseball? And then you're going to play on Friday and Saturday and Sunday, and nobody's paying attention because it's the Sweet 16. You play on Monday. If you open next Monday or Tuesday, you've got all week long. You're the biggest story of the week then. The Final Four isn't until the weekend. What are you doing? You're so myopic. It's crazy. So little national coverage. In terms of the TV coverage of the, there's one game on Thursday that we can see. And I'm not paying $15 a month to see the Braves game on Thursday. I don't even know if the Yankee game is on anywhere. There's nothing that says, you know, that it's on the YES Network. I assume it's on YES, which means I should get it since I'm paying $190-some-odd for extra innings. Oh. I don't understand baseball. As for the tournament, we'll get to the brackets in a moment, but let's start with the SEC and its implosion in round one. I mean, the league got eight teams in the tourney, tied with the Big 12 for the most teams, and only two remain, Alabama and Tennessee. Overall, the league is 5-6, with four of those wins belonging to the Tide and the Vols, and Texas A&M with the other. Three-seed Kentucky and SEC champ Auburn completely embarrassed the league. And I don't want to hear about how Auburn winning the SEC tournament hurt. Oh, this is first thing I saw. Checking the scores. I'm doing my thing there in Tulsa, and I'm checking what's going on. And, Oh, this is why you don't want to win the SEC tournament. Bullcrap. Bullcrap. They had 4 full days off and a first-class plane ride. Bullcrap. Okay? Texas A&M was also in that game last Sunday against Auburn in the SEC championship game. They went out and beat Nebraska in a 9-8 game. So it's a mild upset. Then they took number one seed Houston to the wall before falling in overtime. Bullcrap. I don't want to hear about how, well, this is why you don't want to win the SEC championship because you're going to lose in the first round. Bullcrap. Well, I'm full of piss and vinegar this morning or this afternoon. Just stop with the excuses. Stop. It was pitiful. Pitiful. And so was Kentucky. Now 1-5 in their last 6 tournament games. And you tell me that John Calipari is untouchable? Why? Why is John Calipari untouchable? Because he's got 1 national championship? Why? He's coaching at the basketball equivalent of Alabama. Let me tell you something. If Alabama went 1-5 in their last 6 bowl games, I don't care who the coach is. They wouldn't be there anymore. 1-5 in his last 6 tourney games, unless I'm making that up. And I don't think I am. He's been overrated. His team has been overrated and underperforming for years now. Years. I mean, my goodness, Nate Oates has taken Alabama to back-to-back Sweet 16s. First time that's happened in Tuscaloosa in over 30 years. And Cal can't get out of the first round again? I mean, come on! As for the other 8-team conference, the Big 12, they also have just 2 teams left. And they were 7-6 in the first 2 rounds. The 3 Big East teams, remember the Big East, you know, everybody's like, yeah, Big East got screwed, man. Only 3 teams? Yeah, they're 6-0, and they're all still playing. And the much-aligned ACC, remember, oh, the ACC, oh, the ACC sucks. Oh, the ACC is this. They might only get 3 or 4 teams. And the ACC, they got 5 teams in the tournament. 5 teams got in the tournament from the ACC, and 4 of them are still playing in the Sweet 16. They're a combined 8-1, the ACC. Well, some things don't change. The ACC and the Big East are a combined 14-1 in this tournament. Thursday night, the Tide will play number one seed UNC in L.A., and the Tar Heels are only a 4-point favorite. Jimmy Stein from Bama Online coming up to help us with that. Alabama wearing their whites for their first 2 games. If they play twice in L.A., they'll be wearing their crimson-colored jerseys for both of those games. And what do? You just stay out there for another whole week? What if they were to beat, you know, UNC and Arizona, a couple of certified blue bloods? If that were to happen, the Natty, the Final Four is in Arizona. You just stay out there. You go from Washington State to L.A. to Arizona. See if they can do anything with UNC. You know, they're only a 4-point dog. Did I just say that? They're only a 4-point dog in that game. Jimmy Stein will be joining us to talk about that. Now, ironically, the Bama Online story, I do find this interesting. I went to the Bama Online story about the game, and they have the headline. Let me give you the headline. The headline is, Mo Diabate gives Alabama a late boost to beat Grand Canyon. So that's the headline. The accompanying video is defensive coordinator Kane Womack discussing a spring practice. That's classic. That is so classic. Lines are open, 256-576-4977. You can text the show. The first hour is wide open for you. You can text the show, 7329-TA-SHOW, 732-982-7469. Which is a great way to communicate with us. My X feed is at Tom Abraham Show. Station feed at 97.7 ESPN. We are also on the Facebook at 97.7 ESPN, where you can get a link to our YouTube channel, WZZN TV. Subscribe to that bad boy, will you? Go to 97.7ESPN.com and get links to all of that. And while you're at it, get our apps where you can find links to Zone 2 and 3 and 4, all our alternate streaming channels, which you need because we got so much programming going on this week. Snag the Talk Radio WZZN app as well. We've got all kinds of stuff going on over there. Alabama baseball this weekend with the March Madness on the Zone. Alabama baseball's over on Talk Radio WZZN. So you got to have that. So make sure you get that. The calendar is there to tell you that I've got two lunchtime remotes this week. Tomorrow, Baumhauer's. Thursday, Cojalejos. Two of them. Not one, but two. So the first rule change has come out of the NFL owners' meetings, and they have now outlawed the so-called hip drop tackle. I mean, I guess you know it if you see it. This is something that was adopted from rugby, largely by the Seattle Seahawks. Everybody was like, oh, what a great job the Seahawks are doing teaching a different kind of tackling technique to get the head out of the tackle. Because, you know, this is all about getting the head out of the tackle. We had to get the head. I can't go across the beam with the head. Can't put the face on the ball with the head. We got to get the head out of the tackle. So what did the Seahawks do? They went and adopted the soccer tackle. Or not the soccer tackle, the rugby tackle. They adopt the rugby tackle. Teach the rugby tackle a roll tackle. And now that's outlawed. So now we're giving the officials another arbitrary call to make in a game to keep your team out of the playoffs or out of the Super Bowl. But we don't know how often it's going to actually be called. And will it be a game-changing call? Supposedly they're going to use it more for fines and things like that, where it might not get called in a game, but they're going to fine a guy for it. But it might get called in a game. It might not. It might get called in a critical moment. It might get called on a 3rd and 15 play where you made a stop and you get the ball back and you get a chance to go down and win the game. Oh, wait a minute. Now officials got another chance to call an arbitrary foul, a judgment call. We gave them another judgment call. Wonderful. The NFL Players Association and many current and former players objected to the proposal. The NFL Players Association, the players, former players, current players, the association. In a statement posted to social media, the NFLPA said the rule would cause confusion among players, coaches, officials, and fans. There's no doubt. There's no doubt. And we are still awaiting the vote on changing the kickoff rule to the XFL kickoff rule, which ironically, the UFL will not use this year. The UFL is going to kick off from the 20-yard line. So the threat of their own 20-yard line. So the threat of a touchback is minimal, actually. The coverage teams will get like a 70 to 80-yard run-up on the kickoff. I mean, there are going to be some explosions on the UFL kickoffs, which begin, by the way, on Saturday with our Birmingham Stallions at noon. I'll explain the proposed NFL kickoff, which is, as a special teams guy, to be honest with you, I really like it. You know, I'm a traditionalist. I always say that about everything. I'm a traditionalist. But I actually really like the XFL kickoff rule, and I like the proposal for the NFL. Because the only loss really is the threat of a surprise onside kick, but at least we're going to see returns. We should see returns. But now they made a tweak to the original proposal. They haven't voted on it yet, I don't believe. It's happening during the show here because they're in the meetings now. They're going to vote maybe sometime soon. But there was a tweak in the original proposal that may still have kickers just pounding the ball into the end zone. I'll get to it. Playing the platters that matter in the stacks of wax and answer the phones and keeping us on the air. And thankful that he wasn't wrestling when they had the splatel move. I don't know if he saw the splatel. I mean, the splatel is bad news right there, man. It's the one and only DJ Gizzer Giz.
Who in the blue hell are you? What is your name?
Detective.
It doesn't matter what your name is.
I'm the producer of this show. If I didn't step up, you're nowhere. I put this thing together out of spit and polish.
I think this is one of the traits of a really good producer. Keep the talent happy.
I'm all jacked up on Mountain Dew.
Now, Thom. Hey, Thom.
Testosterone high today. Testosterone, whatever the f*** it is.
It really doesn't matter what you think. It really doesn't matter what you say.
Any of you play sports?
Would you call it, Grizz, a banana split? Is that what you're saying it was called back in the day?
It's called something different to you. It was called banana split to me, and that is definitely something that you don't want to get caught in.
Nasty move.
I don't care if you're in college. I don't care if you're in Little League. I mean, you don't want to get caught in that ever. I mean, the only place you're going is down.
Why did they make that illegal? Yeah, they make the hip drop tackle illegal. I say that wrestling should make the splatel illegal. I mean, you got to look it up, guys. Go and look up splatel. A guy fired one of these in the NCAA championships.
It was Ohio State. I forgot the guy's name, but it was Ohio State versus Nebraska, and the guy put him on his back. And it was
awful looking. How did he not dislocate both hips?
Hey, I'm gonna tell you right now. I've actually had that happen to me before. So
been into splatel?
Yeah,
been into banana splatel.
I was in McEachern, Georgia. We had a tournament. It was my sophomore year, first ever varsity tournament I ever been in. And I got put in that by a two-time state champ. Yeah. It was quick, too. It was a quick match. And the only way you're going to go is down, because literally the only way you can go is put your back on the ground and it's over. So, yeah, it's disgusting. Talking about hip drop tackles, I hate it. I absolutely hate that they're doing this. I think it's stupid. I've gotten to a couple of conversations with coaches about it and stuff like that, and some people are really okay with it. And I'm like, all right, well, then we're just going to, padded, flag football. This is ridiculous. I mean, this is a tackle.
I don't know how you tackle.
Well, how do you chase them down? You going to horse collar again?
You realize that the reason this happened, the reason this was taught, all right, was because of the need to get the head out of the game. You know what I mean?
Now so it's this the is what problem.
Former head coach and defensive expert Dave Wanstead and Pittsburgh Steelers coach Mike Tomlin, a member of the competition committee, indicate the hip drop technique is caused by the fact that we, by rule, lowered every defender's strike zone to avoid a penalty, fine, or suspension for illegal use of the helmet or hits to the head and neck area of defenseless players. Defenders now go low, below the waist, placing the helmet behind the ball carrier rather than in front. Let me stop right there. How many times did you hear the term, the coaching term, across the beam? You always placed your helmet, your face, not your top of your head.
Correct.
Put your face on the ball.
Correct.
All right, put your face across the beam, and the beam would be the spine of the player in the front. You put your face across the beam, right? You can't do that. They say don't do that anymore. Back to the story. Ironically, this style of tackling called hawk tackling was initiated by former Seahawks assistant coach Rocky Seato and widely adopted across the game at every level. It's been lauded by many as an improvement in safe technique. NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell has rightly crusaded to get the head out of the game and has largely succeeded. As a result, as Tomlin pointed out, new techniques have been developed to tackle legally. The hip drop tackle in whatever form is a part of the reaction to new and needed safety measures. And now he can't do that. So what the heck are you supposed to do? What's left?
Supposed to tag him. We're getting to the point of tagging him. I mean, I don't know. Everyone wants to hate to hear that, but it's just, it just shows you the evolution, though, too, of like tackling drills. Like they've gotten worse. Like people used to not be okay with what we had in high school right before the game. I can tell you right now, I had a former coach. I won't say his name. He would have the worst tackling drills before the game, but we knew how to tackle. They looked awful.
You mean he did it in like warm-ups?
Yeah.
No, that's bad.
I understand. But
now, maybe a little guy.
But it's like,
you're talking
even
about
in
what?
Practice,
you're talking
they
about,
don't do it.
You're talking about like eighth grade, JV, and what were you talking about?
No, this was freshman was to all through high school. Yeah.
Well, you don't do that.
Well, okay, I get it.
You shouldn't do that.
But hey, they're not even tackling really anymore.
During
the
week, you do it.
Dummies half the time.
Yeah,
I mean,
I started every single practice with a in the 80s and 90s, now this is, I started every single practice with what we call a form tackle drill. And the form tackle drill was, I would tell the guys, we're not going half speed, we're not going three-quarter speed, we're going 7/8. I would, because I wanted them to learn math, you know what I mean? I said, we're going 7/8, not full speed.
Exactly.
We're not going full speed, but I want to go 7/8 speed. And everybody partnered up, and we did a form tackling drill where one guy would be the ball carrier, hold the ball like you got the ball, and the other guy would wrap up, grab cloth, sink the hips, chop the feet. That was the teaching, okay? It was wrap up, grab cloth around the back, grab cloth, sink your hips. You roll your hips in, chop your feet. And we did it every single day. We did it with pads on. We did it without pads on because we were only going 7/8. We weren't going 100%. We were going 7/8 speed. Now, I don't even know if they do that anymore.
You're teaching them a double leg, basically, in wrestling. I mean, it's doing the same thing. You're sinking your hips. You're driving your feet.
Yeah,
it's no different than a double leg in wrestling. You want to stay centered and full, and you want to have complete control inside the body.
Yeah, that part of it. But I would say that it's more like, because we weren't teaching at the legs. We weren't saying tackle at the legs and lift. We were wrapping up, face on the ball, grabbing the cloth behind the back, and then chopping, rolling the hips and chopping. I would say it would be more like a suplex move. You know what I mean?
Right.
You know, when you're going to suplex a guy, but we're not suplexing.
But like same concept.
Same thing.
But like same concept in wrestling, it's like if your head is back and not into the guy, it's just like a tackle. If you're back, you're going to get ran over. If your face is not in his chest and you're not all the way through, you're going
to,
yeah.
But the face has to be there, because when you drop your head, and I try to teach this guy, but again, I'm doing math. I would teach the guys, I would show them, I'd break out a ruler. I would literally break out a ruler. And I'd say, I want you to see something. When you guys drop your head and tackling, all right, you drop your head and put your arms out. You're like Superman, right? So all you have is your forearms, because your helmet and everything else comes to past your elbow. So all you've got left is like 10 inches of arm left. Now pull your, and I would say, okay, guys, now start lifting your head, pulling your head out, putting your face on it, and go, I'll try and clean it up. Go nipple to nipple. All right, so go nipple to nipple. I used a different term at that time, but that was a long time ago. So go nipple to nipple when you make the tackle. Now all of a sudden your arm is the whole 30 inches. If you have a 32 inches, the whole 32 inches of your arm you have to wrap up with. You drop your head, all you've got is about 10 inches left of arm. You throw your head back, you got the whole 32 inches of arm. Anyway, I don't want to get off the coachy. All right, let's get a break in here. We're wide open for phone calls in the first hour of the show. Natty Danny's already in. Probably wants to know about my driver and 3-wood and 4-wood that I've got in my bag now that I have not swung yet, but I've got. Maybe he doesn't. I don't know. But we'll take your calls next. 256-576-4977 on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Next time you're online looking for landscaping inspiration, open Instagram and check out Southern Gent Landscaping. They can help make your yard your dream outdoor oasis. Southern Gent Landscaping can handle it all, from landscape maintenance and installation to irrigation and hardscapes, even AstroTurf. Turn your yard into a landscape you'll be proud to show off. Call Southern Gent Landscaping at 256-509-6088. 509-6088. Southern Gent Landscaping. Professional landscaping performed with satisfaction guaranteed.
Tired of the same old menu options everywhere you go? Then you need to try Metro Diner in Huntsville and Madison. The award-winning Metro Diner serves up signature dishes like their Charleston shrimp and grits, famous fried chicken and waffles with strawberry butter, and lots more. Their entire menu is available anytime, breakfast, lunch, or dinner. And stop by for brunch on Saturday or Sunday and enjoy the lowest priced mimosas in town. Airport Road, Huntsville, and Highway 72 in Madison. In diner or at home, make it Metro Diner.
Have you ever turned your back on God? Have you ever absolutely known the right thing to do and just turned around and walked away in disobedience? I know that I have. Aren't we thankful for our great and merciful God who loves us and forgives us and remembers our sin no more? I'm so thankful that His mercies are fresh every day. I need that, and I suspect you do too. Hey, I'm John Deese, pastor of Cross Point Church, and if you're looking for a church home, come see us. We're smack dab across the street from the YMCA in Madison, and check us out at cpcfamily.org.
Specializing in simple and affordable rentals, McCurry Van and Car Rental can make sure you have just the right vehicle for your next family vacation, weekend getaway, or if you just need transportation while your vehicle is being repaired. McCurry carries Ford Transit vans and Mercedes Sprinter vans, trucks and work vans, and more. And they offer discounted rental rates for long-term rentals. Now with four locations, Athens, Muscle Shoals, Coleman, and Huntsville. Log on McCurryRentals.com to make your reservation now. That's McCurryRentals.com.
Hi, this is Wes Neighbors. I'm here with Sam Fleming with Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Sam, tell the folks about Fleming Roofing and Restoration.
Hey, Wes. Our company, Fleming Roofing and Restoration, specializes in commercial and residential roofing and repairs. I'm a fifth-generation Huntsvillian, and our family's been doing construction business in Huntsville area since 1965.
Sam, what kind of roofs does Fleming Roofing and Restoration do?
Our guys are skilled enough, we can come out and address any kind of leaks or issues you might have on your commercial, on your metal roofing, on your shingles. We can do anything, and we can offer you a solution to repair it, or we can replace it.
Well, you guys also do insurance restoration.
Our staff has 10-plus years of experience as insurance adjusters, and we really do know the inside and out of the claims process at Fleming Roofing and Restoration.
Check out Fleming Roofing and Restoration online at FlemingHSV.com, or you can call or text them at 256-651-9440.
Hey, Wes, we show up.
From the Fox 54 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Emily Owen. For this Monday night, expect rain and a few thunderstorms to develop mainly after midnight. We'll see low temperatures fall into the upper 50s for the overnight. We'll keep windy conditions in the forecast as well. We could see wind gusts as high as 45 miles per hour. Heading into your Tuesday, rain and a few thunderstorms going to be possible. High temperatures topping out in the upper 60s for the afternoon. I'm Fox 54 meteorologist Emily Owen on your home for ESPN Radio 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Follow us on Twitter, subscribe to us on our YouTube channel and Twitch. Just search 97.7 ESPN. We are 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Segment of the show is brought to you by the service department at Woody Anderson Ford, which is second to none, to be quite honest with you. I mean, if you're going to get your vehicle serviced, you get it serviced at Woody Anderson Ford. It doesn't even matter if it's a Ford or not. If you need a tire rotation or wheel alignment or brake job or an oil change or an engine tune-up, or even if you need tranny work, you need service department, you need a Quick Lane Tire and Auto Center at Woody Anderson Ford. They got you covered. Now, if it's a Ford, they're going to use genuine Ford and Motorcraft parts. If it's not a Ford, what the heck are you doing? All right, check out the certified gold pre-owned vehicles and the new inventory. It's all at the corner of Sparkman and Jordan Lane. It's Woody Anderson Ford, the only place I've gone in the Tennessee Valley for 20 years now. All right, phone lines are open. I've got other topics to get to, but I am going to I'm going to acquiesce to you guys. 256-576-4977 will get you in. Let's take care of Natty Danny, who's been holding patiently. Danny, welcome in. How are you?
Did you say nipple to nipple?
Nipple to nipple. You got chest to chest. Chest to chest is what I should have said. That's right. Chest to
you
chest.
Because like Grumpy. Melon,
Grumpy gets very.
Melon, cantaloupe, coconut,
the coconut. Coconut's your head. Your melon is your head. Your coconut is your head. But Grumpy gets nervous when I say nipple too many times, so I'm not going to say any more this show.
Yeah, don't do that. Yeah, he's right now going, you know, I ain't going to go there, visual. Anyway, right. Hey, listen, you know, by the end of the week, you got to do me a favor. As much as he gave me a hard time, I really need to know how Phillip's doing.
I wish I knew. I can't get a hold of him. I'll check here during the show in the next commercial break. I'll see what I can find at his Facebook page and see if anything is there's been any activity there. But I can't really tell you much because I don't know much about it here. I'm looking at his Facebook page right now. The last thing he posted He has not posted. He hasn't posted at least since January. I'm not seeing anything to him. His cousin, who is my contact for him, I need to reach out to her again, Nancy. I need to reach out to her again because his cousin keeps posting all these things to him, mentioning him on the Facebook, but he's not responding to any of them. So we don't know.
You still have your final four.
I have two of my five. You, by the way, are almost in last place. I mean, that's a good job by you. You are bringing up the rear in our list.
I'm so close to being way up there because the Oregon game was close. Texas A&M game was close. But, Tom, I still have my final four. It's called comeback.
You got all four of your final four left?
You betcha.
How is he? Grizz, didn't you say he's in 158th place or something like that, or 160 or 170?
I got my final four.
All right. Well, that's a good thing. I have two of my final. I have my finalists.
What is your projected amount of points you can get?
Yeah, what's your total projected points is what you got to look at.
I haven't bothered to look at it. I just know I got my final four. So
yeah.
Anyway,
I have two of my final four left. I've got my final left. I got UNC over Houston is my finalist. Yeah. So I do have that left, but that's about it. I got destroyed. Auburn killed me. Kansas killed me and Kentucky killed me. Those three teams are responsible, but apparently I'm not as bad as everybody else. You're in the 150s somewhere. John,
that's okay, but I'm going to move up really quickly because I've got the final four. So.
I think that Captain Cool, my son John Abraham, he has got the best score of anybody of the radio station, and he's 96th. We all suck. I'm 116. Bailey is 116. Scott Tyson is 158. Grizz is 164. Steve Moulton is 178. I mean,
I got three of you guys. I'm beating three of your people at your show. Hey, you know, Tom, I know you're in Florida, and I'm not going to bust your stones, but I think you forgot something in your monologue. But I'm going to give you a pass because, you know, you're busy.
What do you mean I'm in Florida? Why am I in Florida? When did I get to go to Florida?
Bassmaster stuff, or you were doing?
No, that was
like
in that. Tulsa. That was in Tulsa, Oklahoma, and I'm back. Huh. I got back last night. That's over with. Yeah.
So you couldn't keep track of this, but I will say this: it must be said, it must be brought to attention.
Yes.
That the Huntsville Havoc made the first top play in ESPN yesterday.
Yeah, Phil Elkstam with the Michigan play. I saw it when it happened on ESPN. I saw it. We have it posted at the Facebook page for the radio station at 97.7 ESPN. If you guys haven't seen it, the Michigan play, it's a lacrosse play. If you haven't seen it, he scooped up the puck from behind the net and put it on his stick and then flicked it into the goal behind the goalie's head, kind of like scoops the puck up, and just like a lacrosse play, went ahead and stuck it in the net. Now, two things on that, Dan. One, Linda Cohn was doing SportsCenter. The SportsCenter hosts, literally, they do the top 10 themselves. They come up with the top 10. They got researchers, but they come out, they pick the top 10. Linda Cohn, she was a college hockey player. She's a big hockey fan. She played goalie in college in upstate New York. And she, anytime she gets a chance to promote hockey, she'll promote hockey. So that's the one thing. The second thing is, Dan, you know why you don't see that in the NHL? Because a lot of guys can do that. That's something. That's just something a lot of. But you know why we don't? You know why you never see that in the NHL? Because that's followed by a fight usually. There's kind of a code that you don't do that crap. It's cool looking. It's a really cool looking play, but typically when you do that, that's a fight because it's and there's a question about whether or not it's high sticking, because you can't knock a puck down. Your stick can't be higher than the top of the goalpost. When you know what I mean. So if your stick is if the puck is on your stick and you're going over the net and flicking it in that way, you have to be careful. You got to do it from the side. If you notice on that, he goes kind of from the side, because if you go higher than the crossbar, it becomes high sticking because you're touching the puck above the crossbar.
So, well, anyway. Exactly. So I wanted to bring that up because this coincides with the national championship. You can't go anywhere in this country that people don't realize Michigan Wolverines, for crying out loud. That's called the correct pronunciation on that play is called the Michigan goal. That's what they call it. For
it's the Michigan goal.
Ever now, Thom, everybody knows when that happens, it's a Michigan goal. That's how you
Well, did you know that that was called a Michigan goal before it happened?
I know everything about Michigan. Don't go.
Did
there,
you know that was called a Michigan goal? Because I mean, it was the first time we saw it was too. A Michigan. Yeah. That's why they call it the Michigan goal.
Michigan. So everybody, that's just icing. There'll be another something comes up that's going to be awesome. Michigan.
How come you're
put that along with my category with Danny? I'm on a roll this year. I love it.
How come your team, your 158th place team in the bracket challenge, how come it's called Wolverine Dan's not Natty Danny's?
Because my wife did it and she put in the wrong pronunciation of how I'm supposed to be addressed right now. But you know what, Thom? That's okay. I overlook it because the championship trophy resides in my front room.
Yeah. Well, it's good. It's good. Like I said, everybody should.
You guys shut it down on goal line stand.
Everybody should have. Everybody should get one in their lifetime. I'm glad you got one.
Yeah. Well, there's more than one. I got 11. So that's not goal line. Actually, maybe 12 now. So.
Yeah.
All right. Maybe. Hey, I love it, Thom. Hey, listen, listen, man. You know, get better. Whatever you got to do, man. It makes the show better when you're on.
And I appreciate you.
Keep your fingers off your breastnesses.
He does have a potential. Thanks for the call, Wolverine Dan. Grizzly, he does have a potential for 1,610 points, which would move him way up. He does have a potential 1,610. That's good. He sucks. He's at 158, but he could get to 1,610. So we'll give him credit for that. Now, look, these guys are talking. Don't tell me that LSU Lynch and Grumpy are not communicating with each other, because that for them to be back to back like this all the time. Don't tell me that they're not talking to each other. In the order of the longest wait, LSU Lynch is up. LSU Lynch, welcome to the show. How are you?
Son, it's a great day for the Lynchers. Look here, we're going to talk to Havoc real quick. You know,
yeah.
Offensive Tech, it was great night and everything.
Yeah.
My boys, you know, they got chosen to go out there. They didn't select everybody, but they got selected to go do the little, you know, chase tag, you're out kind of thing. And I, you know, my youngest son came in second. Oldest son came in first. What does he do? The camera's on him. He throws his arms up, Thom. Yeah! Right? You know, there's over 5,000 people in there. What? Great, great father moment. Great. Because, I mean, you know, we go all the time. But look here.
Yeah. Over 6,000. By the way, over 6,000. It was 14th straight sellout. Yeah.
15th straight sellout. There's 25. Now, look here. Put this in for. Look here, they only have 25 home games every year, okay?
Yeah.
So look, I mean, just think about it. It was 6,100 to 74 people there that night. I mean, just amazing. But I'm going to tell you what, you're talking about the hot sticking. Look here, we was up 3-1. These damn refs suck all the time, every time. You hear me? They got us. We got two. They put two of our guys in the box. Yeah, you're playing 5-on-3, Thom. You're going to score. You hear me? You hear me? So, yeah. So, you know, LSU Lynch that I am started ref you suck. And what was so funny, I got 2-3-year-old girls right next to me that have season tickets. Son, they yelling. And then we had the fight of the year.
Wait, were they saying ref you suck too?
Yeah.
So wait a minute. Yeah. So you influenced 2-3-year-old girls to say ref you suck?
The whole class.
Okay.
The whole audience. Because that's what we do.
Okay.
We've got banners. We have banners.
So was the fight
ref you suck.
Was the fight after the Michigan goal? Or before?
No. See, look here. What happened was they kept messing with us. Okay.
Yeah.
They messed with our goalie. Our goalie come out to goal and shove their player up against the wall. You hear me?
Yeah.
That's where it started. A little bit later, you know, we had enough. You know, bam. And what was so great is you have 6,000 something people. We got the cowbell going, Thom. After he got through whooping his ass, okay, he thought.
Was it Cole Reginato or who was the guy that went?
I forget who it was. But he just. I mean, it's on Instagram. You can go see it on Instagram. But the whole crowd is on their feet, cheering and yelling, ringing the cowbell as he's going to the penalty box. Hear me?
Yeah.
Now, the Havoc is awesome. We're going to be there military night too.
It'll be interesting to see how the playoff goes for them this year, because they're not, you know, typically they're right at the top and they're going to have to fight their way through. They're like, you know, they're battling that 4-5 hole, and it'll be very interesting to see if they can get on a run in the playoffs.
Well, see, they won 4-0 Friday night, you know, and then look here, the ref killed that game. I'm telling you, and you could just feel the intensity in there. I mean, we had it going. The mojo was going with the crowd that night. I mean, good Lord. But, yeah, these refs are horrible, and it just pisses you off as a fan because everybody sees it. Everybody sees it.
Yeah.
But I'm going to tell you what, it's way better than being a damn Auburn fan right now because you suck.
Well, he got loose there at the end, didn't he? Jumped in there at the end. So he was at the Friday game. The Michigan goal was in the Saturday game that they lost 6-3. He was at the Friday game. Just double check. Yeah, see, they've fallen to 6 now at 59 points, but they're only a few points. They're only 2 points out of 5th. So right now they'd be playing at Roanoke. They're 5 points behind 4th, where they would host Quad City. They were to jump into 5, they would be at Fayetteville. So it's a best of 3, and you play, you know, 2 on the road. If you're 5, 6, 7, 8, you're playing at 1, 2, 3, 4. Right now, the Havoc in 6th place, 52 games in. What, they only got a couple of games left? What is it, 52? I'm not sure exactly how many they got left. I think they play 56. Maybe they got 5 games left. I want to say they got 4 games left. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. All right, let's go to Grumpy. Grumpy, welcome in. How are you?
Hey, pretty good. The most surprising thing that I've learned this weekend is that Wolverine Dan doesn't make Ginger call him Natty Danny.
Yeah, I figured that she was calling him Natty Danny.
Yeah. You know,
that would make sense to me.
That's surprising. I don't know how she messed up that name on that team. But doesn't he have more than one team in that group? Isn't there more than one Dan team?
There are several, but, I mean, we got over 200 people in there, I think. So,
okay.
I mean, well, we can't say he's the only Dan.
I believe that this last weekend was and usually is the greatest sports weekend of the year. And this might be a little painful. I'll be real brief here because this is going to be painful for some people. Because I'm going to mention that the wrestling is huge in some parts of the country, and the finals were this weekend. Around here, it's just like, okay, yeah, what else can we talk about? But that's huge in some parts of the country. I watched it. They had two guys for Penn State, won their 4th consecutive national championship.
Yeah,
Penn State scored more points than any team ever, including all those Iowa teams. It was a lot of fun to watch. That interview that you did for Bassmaster Radio is the single greatest interview done in fishing history. When you interviewed all of those guys and then cut it up to where you could hear from each pro about what they thought about the biggest game changer in fishing history, forward facing sonar. I like that format. I get to hear from everybody all in one interview on and some of them called it a tricky question, whether or not they think about
I'll tell you why, and they told me off air.
Let me take a guess at it first. I didn't think it was a tricky question. I thought they had to give a tricky answer because of sponsorships.
Sponsorship, yeah. They're sponsored. The first guy I talked to who was like being, which was Brock Mosley, former college baseball player, he's sponsored by Garmin, and he was really guarded about it.
Yeah.
What, by the way, what Grumpy's talking about is it's called the Gridwalk. If you ever watch NASCAR, you see when Michael Waltrip will go down through all the cars, and he does a Gridwalk thing. Well, on the day before the Bassmaster Classic on Media Day, all the boats are lined up. All 56 anglers are lined up in their boats, and they sit there, and then the media can talk to them. So I do a special Gridwalk show where I kind of go down, and I ask. So I do 2 or 3 minutes with as many different anglers as I want, and I talk to probably 8 or 10 of them. I don't know how many. And then we put it all together as the 127-minute interview, and I'm just going to, you know, guy after guy after guy. And the theme was forward-facing sonar and a couple of other things that I would ask him. And that's what he's talking about. But, yeah, several of the guys were – you should have seen – I wish we didn't have our camera working properly, so I couldn't do it. Usually that's a video. And I wish you could have seen the looks on their faces because so many of the guys were like – they were talking out of the side of their mouth, and they didn't know what to say because they all hate it. And but they are all sponsored by either Lowrance or Hummingbird or by Garmin, and they just think they have a hard time saying, I hate this thing because, you know, it's a sponsorship.
The first guy you interviewed, he said it was a tricky question, and the first thing I said to myself is, it's not a tricky question, it's got to be a tricky answer.
Yeah, it was tricky for him.
Yeah. So, and then you got the round. This is my case for this was the best sports weekend. You got the round of 32, which I think is the best round because there's so many games to pick from with the NCAA. You got the wrestling championships. You got the Bassmaster Classic. And then in F1, which nobody cares about, but a lot of people do, in F1, Max Verstappen's engine went out, and he couldn't compete. So we had a race. We had a race in F1.
You finally had that guy out. Somebody put sand in his carburetor so get him the hell out of there.
So anyway, that if you think about it, all of the choices that you had this weekend adds up to the best sports, and it kind of flies under the radar, under the sonar, if you will. Okay, and let me quick question: do you get a ring in basketball for the SEC regular season champ, or do you get a ring for the tournament champ, or does basketball not even do rings at the SEC level?
No, they definitely do rings, and the rings are not supplied by the SEC. They're supplied by the teams generally, so it's up to the team whether or not they do that. But I would think you get a ring for that for the regular season, and you get a ring for the for the SEC championship.
Everybody gets a trophy kind of mentality? Would you rather make a Sweet 16 or would you rather win the SEC? And I'll hang up. Thanks.
Would I rather make the Sweet 16 or win the SEC? I'd rather win the SEC championship than just make the Sweet 16. But I'd rather, I would rather make the Final Four than win the SEC championship. Okay, so that's when it gets – second weekend swings things to the big tournament. If Tennessee makes it to the Final Four, nobody will give a rat's butt that they didn't win the SEC tournament. They were the regular season champs, and they think. But if you're gonna go out, at least go out with a SEC championship. I know years where football teams have gotten 4 rings, regular season or division. Regular season or division championship, even. You know, win the West Division, went to the SEC championship game, SEC championship game ring. Bowl ring, won the Rose Bowl, and a national championship ring. I know that there have been years where college football teams have won, one team would win 4 rings. They'd get a pile of rings. All right. Since he mentioned it, let me just say this. The Bassmaster Classic was won by a 33-year-old man by the name of Justin Hamner. Justin Hamner is from Northport, Alabama. Justin Hamner used to work on a grounds crew at the University of Alabama. He is one of the biggest Alabama fans I know. I've fished with Justin Hamner. and we bonded in 2020. We fished a Bassmaster Open together, and we bonded over our love for the tide. And that was, we fished a tournament. It was September 23rd, 24th, something like that. It was right before Alabama played Missouri in the opening game of the 2024 10-game season, the all-SEC season. And we lamented the fact that there hadn't been any football yet and so on. This was the COVID year. And I'm writing a story about it for Bassmaster.com and going into more detail. This kid literally was the guy that was taking care of the grounds around the Walk of Champions. And he was did not have very much money, was married, had a little baby when we met. He had a boat that was a few years old. It was not wrapped. He had no jersey and no sponsors. He had nothing. He was buying $16 rods from Walmart and cutting the end off of spinning rods to make them shorter so he could work a jerkbait without getting a big mark on his forearm. Yesterday, he won $300,000 as the champion of the Bassmaster Classic. And, you know, he had made the Elite Series. I told everybody that would listen to me after I fished with him three and a half years ago, I told everybody who would listen, this kid is going to make it. He's going to make it. I was the one that nicknamed him Hammer Time. We had T-shirts we were making up for him that were Rammer Jammer, Yellow Hamner. Hamner. Justin Hamner. An Alabama guy. Won the Bassmaster Classic. Wire to wire, by the way. All right, we get a break. We will come back. Wrap up hour number one. Brandon, stay put. We'll get to you at some point here. It's Thom Abraham Show, 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
What if I told you that Bigfoot is real and that he's making the best donuts you've ever had? Come see for yourself at Bigfoot's Little Donuts. Come in and order from over 50 flavors, all made hot and delicious. Ranked in the top 100 donut shops in the nation by Yelp. Bigfoot Little Donuts. Order in store or online at BigfootsLittleDonuts.com for pickup or delivery from Grub South or DoorDash. South Parkway, Huntsville and County Line Road, Madison. Bigfoot's Little Donuts.
Eagle Masonry and Insulation. It's right there in the name. Eagle is your one-stop shop for block, stone, or brickwork, monument signs, and outdoor kitchens and fireplaces. Eagle also offers the finest craftsmanship and insulation, including fiberglass or spray foam insulation, and of course, insulation removal. Philip Love and his team have years of experience, bringing the region the best in masonry and insulation services. For more information and a quote, visit insulatewitheagle.com or call 256-755-1556. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
You've got to experience Toyota-thon at Bill Penny Toyota. They've got the selection with over 700 new Toyotas to choose from. And they've got the extras with Bill Penny perks and a 10-year unlimited warranty. So get on over to Bill Penny Toyota today and experience Toyota-thon. Bill Penny Toyota in Huntsville and online at BillPennyToyota.com. Bill Penny's Toyota 10-year unlimited warranty is valid through the 10th year of ownership. Valid on new vehicles only. See dealer for details.
I'm attorney Gary Lackey. If you've been injured and need a lawyer right now and pick up the phone to call, you know, one you've seen on a billboard or on TV begging for your business, do you know who you really get?
I'm attorney Jennifer Lackey. You want to talk to your lawyer. You don't want to reach a call center, not in some office 100 miles away. With the Lackey Law Firm, that never happens. My clients talk to me.
And me. I'm attorney Justin Lackey. We're the ones that you talk to. We're the ones that you meet with.
And we're the ones who handle your personal injury case. You want to talk to me? You just call me.
And we'll take care of it. You worry about getting well. We'll take care of the rest.
The Lackey Law Firm.
And I'll go you one better. If you can't come to us, we'll come to you.
The Lackey Law Firm. The Lackey Law Family. 1-800-4-RIGHTS.
No representation is made that the quality of the legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other lawyers.
The kitchen is the heart of any home. It's where the family gathers. It's where kids discover old recipes and make them their own. Just starting out or just now getting started on the dream kitchen you've always wanted?
I'm Chris Haygood, and from all of us here at Bob Wallace Appliance to the home builders and the homeowners of the Huntsville area, a heartfelt thank you for buying local. We're in Huntsville, Florence, and Coleman, and online at bobwallaceappliance.com.
AL cert number 21014.
Are those high utility bills driving you crazy this time of year? If they are, Talon Heating and Air has the special for you.
That's right. We're going to run a $49 spring checkup on your system. We're going to come out, we're going to check those heat kits, make sure that everything was working through the winter right, and then we're going to also make sure your freon's good, make sure that you're ready for the summertime.
How important is that to be done this time of year?
It's really the most important time of the year. We can avoid safety concerns caused by wintertime use, and then we can also make sure that you're ready for the summertime.
And to get ready for the summertime, you just got to call
256-503-4490.
Or you can find them online at
TalentHVAC.com.
That's Talent Heating and Air. One more time.
256-503-4490.
Talent Heating and Air. Let them save you money.
Situated downtown on Clinton Avenue, you'll find the Church Street family's take on delicious seafood and more. Sea Salt. At Sea Salt, the food speaks for itself. Fresh oysters, shrimp and lobster, and non-seafood fare. Plus a large selection of wines, regional and local beers on tap, and a full bar. Catch the downtown vibe with Sea Salt's unique outdoor city street and patio seating with a view of Jesse Andrews' mural, bringing an underwater world to life. No reservations necessary. Sea Salt, 114 Clinton Avenue.
Welcome back to Thom Abraham Show. This segment brought to you by the Orthopedic Center. The Orthopedic Center is where you go to get fixed, all right? Any orthopedic issues that you have, like my wife is having an issue right now with her hip, and we're going to get her into the Orthopedic Center, have them check her out, and they'll get her right at the Orthopedic Center. I mean, look, that's all the endorsement you need. My son has gone to the Orthopedic Center for his knee, and now my wife will go to the Orthopedic Center. I sent Wolverine Dan to the Orthopedic Center back when he was Wolverine Dan, before they had won a national championship. I'm going to have to send Wolverine Dan, now Natty Danny, I'm going to have to send Natty Danny back to the Orthopedic Center to have his shoulder put back into socket when he gets done patting himself on the back. He's getting a dislocated shoulder. So if you've been put into a splaydal and you need to be put back together, you go to TOC. Even if you haven't, it's TOC. All right, coming up, Jimmy Stein from Bama Online. Does it rhyme so nice? He'll join us next. We'll talk some Alabama with him as the Tide have made it to the Sweet 16 for just the second time in over 30 years. I think it was 91, 92, something like that, where they went back-to-back to the Sweet 16. Do we got anything for UNC? The Tar Heels. We'll talk about that matchup next, right here on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
The Broncos have not yet signed a replacement for former starter Russell Wilson or improved their draft position to give them a better chance to select their future franchise quarterback. But Coach Sean Payton isn't panicking right now about the situation. Told reporters at the NFL owners' meetings today they've got a pretty good plan in place. Broncos understand what they're doing, and they're going to be smart about it. Added, it is realistic to think Denver could trade up from its current spot at 12 in next month's draft. And revealed they did conduct a private workout with Michigan quarterback J.J. McCarthy the day after his pro day. ESPN's Mel Kiper Jr. has McCarthy currently going to the Vikings at 11. Dodgers superstar Shohei Ohtani will publicly talk to the media today. For the first time since theft and gambling allegations emerged against his former interpreter Ipe Mitsuhara, the IRS and MLB are conducting separate investigations into the matter.
College football.
The ball is caught. It is
is a touchdown!
Major League Baseball.
That ball is gone! A home run!
This is your place for complete sports coverage all year long. 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
It's a beautiful day for a ball game.
Here it comes, and there it goes. Fly ball, deep left field, way back. This one is up. This one is gone.
Grab your peanuts and Cracker Jacks and get ready to cheer on the Tide.
Called third strike, a slider lower inside corner.
The Tide plays here all season long.
Here's a spin. Here's Bowman's throw home. The slide, and he's safe.
On your home for Alabama baseball, the Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
Tom Luganbill here for my friends at Woody Anderson Ford. Bobby White and his team take great pride in their service department, and you can see it the moment you walk into those beautiful new service lanes. And just like a championship team, they all work together to make sure your experience is second to none, whether you drive a Ford or not. Also, check out the gold certified pre-owned inventory at Woody Anderson Ford for great deals every day. Stop by and see them at Jordan and Sparkman or at Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, or visit WoodyAndersonFord.com.
The new favorite place for delicious Mexican food is Coralejos Mexican Grill in Huntsville. Check out their reviews on Facebook and you'll see what people are raving about. Enjoy drink specials all day Monday through Thursday, like house margaritas for $3.99 and 12-ounce drafts for $2. Even vegan-friendly entrees on Monday starting at 5. Beginning Friday morning, get $50 worth of delicious food from Coralejos Mexican Grill for just $25 with our zone deal at 977ESPN.com. Coupons good for food purchase only.
This is Brent Musburger's VSiN Action Update on 97.7 ESPN The Zone. Unlike other credit cards that decline sports betting transactions or treat them as a cash advance, the GBank Visa Signature Card can load directly to your favorite sportsbook apps. G.Bank/VSiN.
Men's Hoops Sweet 16 on Friday. South Region second seed Marquette by 6.5 against 11th seed NC State. Top seed Purdue favored by 4.5 against 5th seed Gonzaga in the Midwest Regional. Houston by 3.5 against 4th seed Duke. Houston the top seed in the South Region. Midwest Regional second seed Tennessee by 2.5 against 3rd seed Creighton. Connecticut's the betting favorite to win the national title at plus 220. Houston plus 600. Purdue plus 650. Arizona plus 1,000. Women's Hoops tonight, second round. Top overall seed Iowa by 15.5 against 8th seed West Virginia. Get the latest lines and more at vsin.com.
Our steady diet consists of food and football and occasionally some baseball and hoops.
Did you eat a lot of paint chips when you were a kid?
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
You need to be more like a dog.
Like what you guys are doing. You've got your fingertip on the pulse of your listeners. Guys know what they're talking about.
Be a dog.
God bless the show. You are the Messiah.
We need more dog.
This is the best show on radio.
The Big Dog, Thom Abraham, is here with you.
Hey, I see you, dog.
So settle in and get your bark on.
That's my dog.
Now live. Here he is, the Big Dog.
Let's go, baby.
Thom Abraham.
How you doing?
Look, I don't speak Spanish.
I don't know how to say this, so I'm going to choose my words very carefully. I think you're a psycho.
Do you know who I am?
I mean, that guy sounds like Elle McPherson farting into Miles Davis' trumpet.
I guess I'm on here. Am I on? Can somebody respond?
Get off my own.
I have to drag my Yankee ass out of here.
Hey, welcome back. Hour number two of the Thom Abraham Show on a Reaction Monday. Plenty of tournament reaction. We got more reaction on some of the things that are going on at the NFL owners meetings. We'll get you caught up on some of the rule changes and proposed rule changes that are coming there as well. We'll tell you that this segment of the show is brought to you by North Alabama Mortgage. Whether you're in Alabama, Tennessee, or Florida, North Alabama Mortgage has you covered for all your mortgage needs. Get a home valuation and see what you can do by refinancing or buying with North Alabama Mortgage's team of experts in your corner. Take advantage. The rates are falling. They're going to continue to fall. Go ahead and pull the trigger now, and you can refi later. Average home equity at an all-time high. Take advantage of that. Brian Hammaker and his team, North Alabama Mortgage, there to help take care of you. All right, joining us now, a guy that does a tremendous job covering all things Bama, that is Jimmy Stein from Bama Online. I just like saying that. I mean, I could talk to Charlie Potter, or I could talk to, you know, to Clint Lamb or whatever, but that they don't rhyme with Bama Online. So I got Jimmy Stein from Bama Online, and he joins us now on the Neighbors Wealth Management Hotline. Jimmy, welcome back. How are you?
Oh, I'm doing great. That's exactly why I applied to Bama Online. It just made so much sense. It was poetic, right?
It just it sounds better than saying Jimmy Stein from On Three. You know what I mean? It sounds better than it's Bama Online. I actually reached out to Charlie at the same time I reached out to you, but I assume he's running up and down the coast. There's no reason for the Tide to come back, right? They're staying out there. They just as soon stay out there for another couple of weeks, probably, if they could.
No, that's right. I think the finals in Phoenix, so might be a while before we have those guys back in Tuscaloosa. But yeah, Charlie Potter with our side at BOL, he's headed to LA shortly.
Yeah. So I guess when Mo is going the other way, you stop it by putting Mo in for Alabama, right? Because boy, when that kid came in the end of that game, it just kind of took over. I mean, it looked like, Grand Canyon's going to do something again here, and everybody's going nuts, and they're showing the Grand Canyon crowd back at their home place and all this stuff. And Mo Diabate comes in there, and that's the end of that. He kind of shut it all down.
Yeah, there was a point in the game when things were going really well for the Antelopes that I really felt like someone had to step up and help Mark. I mean, Mark was unbelievable, as he is virtually every game out, and he was really carrying the team. But you really can't just put it all on one guy, and someone had to step up. It ended up being Mo Diabate, and I'm not sure that would have been among my top three or four or even six guesses as to who was going to step up and help Mark win this game. But it was definitely Mo. I think he scored 9 points in just 12 minutes. You know, that works out to be a pretty good game if you do that over 40 minutes. He was great. I really think it's the toughness. It's not so much that he scored the points, and they were all huge, even his free throws. He was a less than 50% free throw shooter on the season and then was 3 for 3. With the season on the line last night. So a real clutch performance. But what Mo really brings and what Alabama sorely needs is just that toughness. I mean, at 6'7", he can bang with bigger guys, even though he's a freshman, even though he's an inch or two shorter than the ideal power forward. Mo is just tough, and I really think his toughness is contagious. The whole team plays a little tougher when Mo's out there.
No doubt about it. 9 points and 5 boards in 13 minutes. He had 12 minutes in the first round of the tournament. Also had 9 points and 5 rebounds. So this guy, a little instant offense, and the rebounding, of course, is very, very important. All 5 of his rebounds were offensive rebounds in the game against Grand Canyon. So that was important. And look at this. The Tide allowed 61 points. That's a half usually for them. I mean, you know, they showed that they can play a little bit of defense when they need to, and that'll be critical going forward, I think, is the ability to play some defense.
I think they played better on defense in the first game. Not a lot of people noticed, because at the end of the game, you just noticed that the opponent scored over 90 points, you know, over the total of the game. But there was a time in the second half when Alabama was up 31. Up to that point in the game, I thought Alabama had played really well defensively, and last night against Grand Canyon was just more of a carryover, I think, from that stretch of round one where they also played well. I think all of Nate Oates harping on the defense, all the work they've done has just sort of paid off late, and they're tougher. I don't know at any point during the regular season, Tom, that they would have won that game last night. I think last night was the culmination of all the work that it took to win a brawl like that. I really feel like in round one, they won a beauty contest. They played exactly the way they play. They played exactly the way they want to play. They scored over 100 points. It was beautiful. It was exactly as they designed it. But then in round two, they needed to win a brawl. Completely different game. Beauty contest, They won that. Then there was a brawl. They won that. That's what's been so impressive about their run.
Yeah, Mark Sears with 26 points. He said that Mo Diabate won them the game in the last 5 minutes. That's a nice thing for him to say. But they went about half of the games they won without that kid Mark Sears this year. I mean, and when he rattles in that that deep three, you know, from you know, right down the middle, to kind of stem the tide a little bit there late, and then he has the good drive and that beautiful pass, that dump off pass for the flush, as they start to pull away a little bit late. You know, those are the types of things that Mark Sears brings to the table. And he's just been amazing. He's the All-American that he is, you know.
When this season ends, one of the things I'm looking forward to, I'm going to do a deep dive on this on BOL. I want to compare Mark's season to the previous great single seasons in Alabama history. I'm not saying Mark Sears is one of the great players Alabama's ever had, or that his name belongs alongside the Brandon Millers and the Reggie Kings and, you know, just the great Robert Horry, the great Alabama greats of all time. But Mark's season, this season, has probably been as good as any Alabama player ever in terms of the production, the nightly production. As we all know, he's scored many more 20-point games. He's registered many more than Brandon Miller did a year ago. He's completely carried this team. Last night he did it on the defensive end too. He's tough. He rebounds extremely well for a guard, scoring underneath the basket as he does so consistently, even at 6'1". It really has been one of the most special seasons that an Alabama basketball player has ever put together here.
Yeah, it's been an incredible season, and he's going to have to be great against number one seed UNC, you know, out west to kind of keep this thing going here. You know, and it's not like they haven't looked across the way and seen the Tar Heels before and done well. I think they won the last game that they played. It was like, what was it, 105, 101 or something like that. It was some crazy score that they won the last time they were out there. So, and they're only a 3.5, 4-point dog, which I think is very interesting as well.
Yeah, there's a lot of respect for Alabama out there. I was a little surprised at the line. I thought it would be a little higher. Alabama matches up well with Carolina. Again, they saw them a year ago and beat them, though it was three or four overtime.
Four overtimes.
Just a nutty game. And then Carolina ended up not even making the tournament, which is crazy because I think they barely missed the tournament. Had they beaten Alabama with Alabama's net ranking and RPI and all that stuff, had North Carolina won that game, they might have been in the tournament. But they're an outstanding team. They can beat you a number of ways. I think they will be a team, Tom, that won't mind running with Alabama. You know, Alabama wants to play up and down the court. I think Carolina's pretty comfortable with that. But Carolina's also good in the half court because they have the big guy inside that they can really lean on. They have Reed at guard, who's a tremendous scorer. This is a good team. They don't play many guys. I was looking over their stats. They generally only play seven or eight guys, and that's it in terms of the critical minutes of the game. I think Alabama's going to want to run, and they might dare Carolina to run with them, but I also don't think Carolina's going to shirk away from that challenge because I'm sure they feel like they can go athlete per athlete with Bama.
Yeah, and all the pressure is on Carolina here, right? I mean, you look at Alabama back-to-back Sweet 16s. They haven't done that in like 30 years, and it tells you how hard this is. Like you say, Carolina didn't even make the tournament last year. This year, they're a one seed. They're the bluest of blue bloods that are out there as well. But you look at Kentucky. I mean, they're 1-5 in their last six tournament games and can't seem to get out of their, you know, get out of their own way in the tournament. So what the Tide have done going back-to-back Sweet 16s is really a thing. But then on top of that, the expectation, all the weight is on Hubert Davis's shoulders and on the Carolina's shoulders because the Tide now, it's kind of like borrowed money, you know, Sweet 16 team once again and trying to get to some place they've only been, I think, once before to the Elite Eight.
That's exactly right. I don't think anyone at Alabama was talking about Final Fours and Elite Eights before the season started. Alabama was picked to finish fifth in the SEC. Before the season started, which was fair. Boy, a lot's changed, though. You know, I think there was some an expectation maybe that Grant Nelson would be the best player on this team. That obviously didn't work out. Grant's an important player on the team, and he's a starter for a reason. But as we all know, this became Mark Sears' team, not Grant Nelson's team. A lot's changed. But what never changed was the idea that this Alabama team was a Final Four team or an Elite Eight team. At Carolina, they start talking about Final Fours in July and August. I mean, you know, it's the annual expectation, even though it might not always work out that way. It's a tough sport. But Carolina expects to win Thursday night. They have been assuming a win in the round of Sweet 16 for weeks and months in Chapel Hill, North Carolina. Alabama not feeling just lucky to be there. It's their third trip in 4 years. But Alabama's obviously this is a territory that North Carolina sort of owns, and Alabama's going to have to play really, really well to win this game.
Talk about what Nate Oates has done, you know, taking a team back-to-back to the Sweet 16 now and looking to go even beyond, and the fact that he signs a new contract. Should that make everybody feel comfortable? Because I think anybody – It's kind of a natural thing when you think about Alabama, and then you think about some of the perceived blue blood jobs that could and might be open. I dare say the people in Lexington wouldn't mind having Nate Oates right now coaching that team, you know, and recruiting up there. But having said that, there's always that the better they do, the more you worry about him, you know, being gone. But it seems like he's very, very comfortable in Tuscaloosa, and it seems like, you know, he wants to continue to take this team to higher and higher levels.
Well, the buyout that he agreed to tells us all about how happy he is at Alabama. It's a large buyout in his extension. Alabama's making a heck of a commitment to Nate Oates, making him one of the top five highest paid coaches in the sport. But it's also a heck of a commitment that Nate Oates is making to Alabama by agreeing to the buyout. That's Alabama saying, hey, we're going to do something for you here, but you got to do something for us too. And that's agreeing to the large buyout, which sort of takes him off the radar for a Kentucky or a Michigan or an Ohio State, these premium jobs recently opened, Louisville. If Nate Oates had a more of a traditional buyout or even a no buyout, Nick Saban in all of his contracts that he ever signed with Alabama, there was never a buyout by his insistence. With Nate Oates, there's a very high buyout, and it just kind of takes him out of the running for those jobs. Otherwise, you would see his name associated with all of it. But Nate is clearly very happy at Alabama. He wouldn't have agreed to it. And Alabama is very clearly happy with Nate and wants a long-term deal that he has more than earned. Three Sweet 16s and four seasons at Alabama is just amazing. All that's left is the breakthrough run to the Elite Eight and the Final Four. And it may or may not happen this week, but I think all of us know it's going to happen eventually. Coach Oates is just too good, and he recruits one heck of a roster every year.
Jimmy Stein with us from Bama Online. Speaking of buyouts, were you surprised at all at how small the buyout was for Kalen DeBoer? I mean, it starts at $5 million, and it goes away, I think, in 3 years. And you mentioned Saban never having one. Okay, that's Saban. But, you know, they gave him a big contract, fourth highest-paid coach in the country, you know, closing in on $11 million a year. But easy for him to leave and easy for Alabama to cut him loose if it's not working out, it seems like. It was, I thought, was quite interesting to see how little or how small that buyout was.
Well, Jimmy Sexton, I mean, he dominates this industry, you know, and he, you know, every contract's different that Jimmy Sexton works with his different clients. Every client is different. Every school is a little different. But in general, no one's better at negotiating those deals than Jimmy Sexton. So if Kalen DeBoer didn't want a big buyout, meaning that, you know, should Kalen DeBoer leave for another job or choose to leave for another job, it wouldn't be a daunting payout for the new school or NFL franchise or whoever did it. I'm sure that's something that Sexton wanted. And he ends up getting what he wants in a lot of these deals.
Yeah, it does seem that way. I chuckled a little bit when I saw the story at Bama Online that Charlie Potter posted. The headline, Mo Diabate gives Alabama a late boost to beat Grand Canyon. And the accompanying video is Kane Womack, defensive coordinator, talking about practice, talking about his spring practice. And I said that to a couple of my national guys, and I go, this is the way they roll down here. And they just got a chuckle out of it, and hearing that pretty much says it all. But I did find that kind of interesting. And, of course, spring ball I don't know that it takes a backseat at all, even to a run in the NCAAs. You know, I've talked about my history here when I first got here, having to cover the A-Day game as opposed to an Elite Eight game back in 2004 when that happened. And it was like the station I was working for at the time kicked the Elite Eight game to our sister station so that our primary sports station could carry the spring game. And, but it,
on brand.
Yeah, it is on brand a little bit. Talk to me about the added access that you guys have had, and you know, what you're learning a little bit from about the staff, the way they work, and the fact that we get to hear from them, you know, throughout spring ball.
Well, it's been tremendous for us in the media. I assume all the fans feel the same way. It's been so interesting, even using terms like the coaches even talk in terms that Nick Saban himself, when Coach Saban taught the media, he would never say things like, "Well, Zabian Brown and Red Morgan are running with the ones."
Yeah,
that is nothing Nick Saban would have ever have said, and that's
he
not
didn't have ones. Say, he never had any ones, is what it was.
He never acknowledged there was a depth chart until basically the day of a game. But the new staff does, and that's not to say that Coach Saban was exactly right in doing it his way, and the new staff is wrong, or vice versa. But we are enjoying the access, hearing from all the assistant coaches, hearing from more players than usual. You get a lot of great information from those interviews, too. They're not shy about telling you, you know, answering the question that's asked, even if it involves giving away what the theoretical depth chart looks like. They've also not been shy about bragging on the players and about how talented many of them are. They haven't shied away from building up, I guess, what you might say, expectations as it relates to some of the freshmen, for instance. So we've loved the access. Gives us a lot more to write about, gives us a lot more to talk about. And it's great getting to know the personalities of the assistant coaches, which is something you didn't really have under Nick Saban.
Yeah, and of course, the big news that popped last week was Caden Proctor and his impending return. I was in Tulsa on a different assignment for the last week. Has anything changed in that? I mean, I know that transfer portal doesn't open up until April 15th, but I mean, it's all indications are that Caden Proctor, the once and future Crimson Tide left tackle.
Yeah, I would call it a verbal commitment. I mean, yeah. Caden Proctor can't sign or he can't enroll until the semester has ended. He can't sign with Alabama until he enters the transfer portal. That's April 15th. But he did indicate on his own personal Instagram account. He tweeted a picture. I think he used a Michael Jordan meme or a Michael Jordan when Jordan said, "You know, I'm back." When Jordan returned to the NBA after playing baseball. So I would count that as a verbal commitment that Caden Proctor has made. Nothing's official. But it's certainly all indications are Caden Proctor intends to enter the portal on April 15th and then sign with Alabama, or I should say re-sign with Alabama. Very unique situation. Not sure I can recall another one, certainly not at Alabama, but even from around the country where a player enters the portal, leaves, then returns to the same school before even the expiration of the semester in terms of the timing. Now, again, Caden can't re-enroll at Alabama until the summer one session, which starts around June 1st. But all indications are he'll be back and he'll be welcomed back. You're talking about one heck of a talent. The ceiling is very, very high for him. Alabama needed a portal tackle. I'm not sure they could have handpicked a better one in terms of how good this kid can be and just his comfortability. He knows where everything is. I mean, you don't have to tell him where the mess hall is or how to get to Taco Casa. You know, he's been to Tuscaloosa, so he's going to be comfortable here and has a lot of friends on the team.
I don't think he ever had to tell that kid where the mess hall was, but you know, he was better at the end of the season. There were times where he looked like he was stuck in the mud and the concrete early in the year, but he got better as the season went on. It's funny, I'm looking at his Twitter page and back on January 20th, there's a picture posted. The newest Hawkeye at Caden Proctor is in the house. He's at a basketball game, in an Iowa basketball game, and he's surrounded by Iowa fans wearing the black and gold Iowa gear. He has a crimson hoodie on in the picture, so he should have known it could have been trouble there. And then the next picture was, it says, "Don't worry, fans. Caden Proctor put an Iowa shirt on, so now he's wearing an Iowa. He took the crimson hoodie off, and he's got an Iowa T-shirt on. And then, it all comes crashing down. You know, does anybody know what happened? He couldn't have been homesick. He went home. What happened? I don't think he was run off by Iowa. They probably haven't even had spring ball yet. What happened? You know that this happened.
Yeah, probably money? We won't know until there's a full. Probably won't know until there's a full interview. I personally doubt it has much to do with NIL type situation, because as high profile as Caden was, I'm sure he had a pretty good NIL situation in Alabama when he left, and probably had a pretty good one at Iowa when he was there. I don't think that's going to be a major factor here. All we can really do is guess until Caden is interviewed and puts things out publicly. My guess would just be Caden felt after experiencing Iowa and experiencing Alabama that perhaps Alabama was better preparing him for an NFL future in terms of what he would see on the practice field every day, and being pushed and having to, you know, at Alabama, you know, every day at practice, you're pass protecting against a guy that's going to be a high pick in the NFL draft. You're surrounded by teammates who are also future pros. Not to say that Iowa, you know, I'm not trying to make it out to where Iowa is a William and Mary or FCS school. Iowa is a good program, especially for offensive linemen. They've produced so many NFL players. The head coach is a former NFL offensive line coach. So it's not like Iowa's not a good program for his development, but I'm just guessing Caden Proctor felt better developed for an NFL future at Alabama. But that's a guess on my part.
Always a pleasure. Jimmy Stein from Bama Online has been our guest. Jimmy, appreciate you so much, and we will look forward to chatting down the road.
Hey, appreciate it, Tom. Thanks.
Thank you. Alan Clemens, longtime writer, outdoor writer, noticed a post that I made about the kid from Tuscaloosa, Justin Hamner, winning the Bassmaster Classic, and he says, I hope you do something on this on your show. The rest of the state's news media, quote, news media, including his hometown pub outlet, doesn't have shinola about it, which is a rotten shame. I mean, you're talking about 15,000 people at the weigh-in. You're talking about hundreds of thousands of people that were watching on TV and online. And you're talking about a $300,000 paycheck, a win that's worth $1 million for him as, winning the Bassmaster Classic, and certainly he will be on Bassmaster Radio this week as the winner. You know, I, you guys tell me. I mean, you know, Sweet 16 starts on Thursday. Major League Baseball starts on Thursday. If you would be interested at all in hearing this kid, you know, I'll have him on the show in the next day or two. You know, I can put him on this show here on Tuesday or Wednesday as a kid from Alabama that won the Bassmaster Classic. If you want it. If you want to just save it for Saturday, then you'll hear the interview that I do with him on Saturday. But on this show, I could do a little bit more about Alabama and what it was like to work on the grounds there and be a part of that whole thing while he was pursuing his professional fishing dream. All right, we got a break in here. We come back. Phone lines go open the rest of the show. 256-576-4977. You want to jump in? You can jump in. We got a few things to get to. Some news that's coming out of the NFL owners meeting. And what did Mike Tomlin say about his quarterback room that features Russell Wilson and Justin Fields? We'll tell you that next on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
You're listening to the Thom Abraham Show on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
No payments for 90 days on 23 and 24 models. Financing as low as 0%, and the best deals of the year on America's best-selling truck for 47 years in a row. Hi, folks. Bobby White back again for Woody Anderson Ford, and I'm here to tell you it's Truck Month. The best deals on F-150, Explorer, Bronco, Edge, Bronco Sport, and Escape. During Truck Month, get financing as low as 1.9% for up to 72 months on 2023 F-150 Crew Cabs, and lease payments as low as $375 a month. That's a 36-month lease with $6,282 due at signing, zero security deposit, just tax, tag, title, and your good credit. Offer ends 4/2/24. Call 539-9441 for complete details. At Woody Anderson Ford, we have over 40 Bronco Sports and nearly 50 Explorers and about a dozen full-size Broncos, all with great sales incentives and no payment for 90 days. Truck Month only happens once a year. Woody Anderson Ford, hope to see you soon.
The company is Eagle Masonry and Insulation, but did you know they're also Eagle Landscaping and Dirtwork? Eagle can take care of all your landscaping needs, including irrigation, sod work, and planting, both plants and trees. On the dirtwork side, Eagle can grade and build your pads, haul dirt in or out, and even do erosion control. Philip Love and his team can do it all for you. The website is the same, insulatewitheagle.com, as is the phone number, 256-755-1556. Give them a call and see what Eagle can do for you. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
Hi, my name is Dan Aldridge. I'm here to let you know about the Aldridge Law Firm and the soon-to-be-announced Legal Town Center. I've been practicing law in Alabama since 1984, and I also practice in Tennessee. And I'm from North Alabama, and I'm here to represent you and take care of your legal needs. For many of us, hiring an attorney is not high on the priority list, and maybe a little scary. But it's something that we all need at some point. So by all means, do your homework. And if you need representation for car accident, wrongful death, medical malpractice, nursing home abuse, or estate planning, or any other matter, just give us a call at 256-534-3188. And you can email me at Dan, that is Dan at danaldridgelaw.com. Dan at danaldridgelaw.com. God bless America.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other lawyers.
The good folks at Wendy's have a revolutionary new product for you. Introducing the new Orange Dreamsicle Frosty. It's like a time machine that takes you all the way back to now, the year 2024. It's the classic, creamy, orangey flavor you remember. Dare I say, it's new timey. It's the flavor you grew up with, just all grown up. Head over to your local Wendy's establishment and get yours while supplies last. The new Orange Dreamsicle Frosty. Here for the now, for now.
Limited time only at participating Wendy's.
Bailey Equipment Rental has grown by leaps and bounds over the past year and is adding more and more equipment to their already impressive fleet. Bailey is a locally owned family equipment rental business serving the entire Tennessee Valley. They concentrate on the local contractors, building repeat business and specializing in long-term rentals for their local contractors. The benefit of long-term rental is that they stay on top of their assets. If something you own goes down in a field, you have to stop and fix it before you can finish the job. With Bailey Equipment Rental, they will fix it on site or bring you another machine while that one's being fixed. More importantly, Valley is locally owned and operated, which means when you have an issue, you can get someone on it right away, right here in the Valley. Heck, ask for Ross Roberts, the owner, if you like. Try calling one of the big box national outlets and asking for the owner. That's if you can even get through the automation. Buy local. Buy Valley Equipment Rental. Valley Equipment Rental has two locations, one on the North and South Parkway. Learn more at valleyequipmentrents.com.
If you enjoy 97.7 ESPN The Zone for all the best in sports talk, you'll love Talk Radio WZZN on 97.7 HD2. Don't have an HD radio? No worries. Download the app by searching for Talk Radio WZZN on your phone or visit the website at Talk Radio WZZN. Talk Radio WZZN features the best in talk from Fox News Radio during the day, plus Bill O'Reilly and his no-spin news at 6. Your home of the Rocket City Trash Pandas is Talk Radio WZZN.
This is Paul Feinbaum. Listen to me coming up today at 2. Now back to the Thom Abraham Show on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
I'm ready for Show. Segment of the show is brought to you by Valley Equipment Rental with their two locations. Valley Equipment Rental can take care of everything that you need to get the job done like a pro. It's Valley Equipment Rental. And if you are a pro, you need to be thinking about Valley Equipment Rental and long-term rentals. As a former contractor myself from a construction family, I can tell you that long-term rentals is the way to go, especially when you got great equipment like they've got at Valley Equipment Rental, whether it's an excavator, a mini excavator, a dozer, a skid steer, compressors. You go with that stuff, and then what happens is when it, you know, if it goes down, boom, they just bring out another one, haul that one away, and they'll get that one ready to go, or they send their mechanic out and get it going again right there on the spot. Whereas if it's your own piece of equipment, you're dead in the water, man. You're just dead in the water. You know, what you do, then what you do is you got to call Valley Equipment Rental. Said, bring me an excavator. Mine is down. And you might as well just go with Valley Equipment Rental right from the beginning. Two locations, North Parkway and South Parkway, is where you will find Valley Equipment Rental. So I was just watching some video of Nick Chubb was trending on X. And so I got to click on that. When he's trending, you know, it's one of my guys. He's trending. And so I click on it, and I'm seeing all these fantastic runs, especially from his rookie. His eighth and tenth carries as a pro were both over 50-yard touchdown runs against the then Oakland Raiders. I mean, anyway, so it got me thinking about Georgia running backs, which got me thinking about Trevor Etienne. How about that dude getting himself right in, grained with the Georgia, with the Georgia culture there? Got himself transferred from Florida. Got himself into Georgia, got himself a DUI, reckless driving, failure to maintain lane, improper driving, and a road of, look, this can't be an Athens thing. This isn't like the Athens, you get to Athens and water there is vodka or something. I mean, this is ridiculous. I hate to make light of it because you had a guy get killed a few years back. But what is it with this Georgia Bulldog program? And they need to have like a NIL deal with Uber or something and never drive again. Nobody. I mean, Travis Etienne, first of all, what are you doing out at 4:35 in the morning?
Yeah.
Coming home.
Club.
Hammered. Well, there's nothing Bar. That happens good at 4:35 in the morning unless you're waking up at 4:35 in the morning to go fishing. You don't be coming home at 4:35 in the morning. You're going fishing at 4:35 in the morning. Goodness gracious almighty. He was booked into the Athens Clark jail. He was released an hour later after posting bond. Another Georgia player jammed up.
These college kids can post bond pretty well, too.
Yeah.
Got NIL money for that, maybe.
No. No. Who knows who's posting? Maybe they got a guy. They got a bag man that posts the bonds for all of them. You know, that's what they probably got. They probably got, you know, an NIL deal with Grumpy's Bail Bonds. By the way, Grumpy's Bail Bonds is an actual sponsor of mine when I was in Nashville. That's a true story. There's a company called Grumpy's Bail Bonds, and they sponsored my show when I was in Nashville. All right, let's go to the lines. Brandon is up. Brandon, welcome to the show. How are you?
Man, I am having a great day yourself.
I'm fantastic.
5 assists for Grand Canyon in that ball game last night, if I understand Chuck correctly.
Something like that.
I wonder if there's ever been fewer assists in a tournament game than last night.
Well, I think they had one guy. Griffin or whatever his name is, and one guy had like 30 points and everybody else was single digits. I mean, that was a one-man band right there.
Yeah, I just wonder, in the second round, has there ever been a team that had fewer than 5 assists? That's right. Got to be some kind of record.
Could be.
So your guy gone from groundskeeper to Bassmaster winner.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. I fished with him. I'm writing a story about it. I fished with him in September of 2020. And I told at that time he was a Bassmaster Opens angler, which is the AAA level of professional fishing. And you know, he was trying to make it to the elite, you know, series. And I just told everybody that I was fishing. I said, this kid here is the best jerkbait fisherman that I've ever seen. And if he doesn't make the elites, I'll be stunned. And he made the elites the next year. And he finished fourth in the 2022 Bassmaster Classic. And he had won about $250,000 to $300,000 so far in his career, and he just doubled it over this past weekend by winning the Classic.
Well, I hope you hook him up with your accountant so he can figure out how to finesse as many tax breaks as he can with that when he probably purchases a new home.
So it's just a different thing. Yeah, it's a different world for him. He was working on a grounds crew at the university. He absolutely loves Alabama. It's from Northport, obviously right there. But absolutely loves the university. Everything is roll tide with him. He would after every fish catch on TV, after every fish catch, he'd roll tide. He'd drop a little roll tide in there. And then on the stage at the weigh-ins, I was at the weigh-ins Friday and Saturday. I didn't stay for Sundays because I had to get back here, got to do this job here on a Monday. So I drove back from Tulsa yesterday, watched it last night on TV on Fox, on FS1 it was last night. And, he dropped the roll tide, and they're very emotional. He doesn't have the most personality in the world. We kind of talked about that, and I talk to him all the time now, and kind of talk to him a little bit about trying to open up the personality a little bit. He's very laid back, kind of guy. But it's a rotten shame, and I haven't been to AL.com today to check. But what Alan Clemens is saying, I mean, we have no newspapers anymore to speak of, it seems like. But that's a big deal, and for that not to get some love, that an Alabama kid, in the heart of fishing, really, professional fishing in the country is the state of Alabama. We have so many anglers that live here. And for an Alabama kid that calls Tuscaloosa home, that used to work on the grounds crew, and the last couple of years he was still running his own little landscape company to try and fill in the gaps, make sure he had enough money to fish these tournaments, that this kid has gone out and won the Bassmaster Classic. It's a real rags-to-riches story. It really is.
Well, speaking of fishing, I guess for anniversary number 15, myself and the wife, we're going to go up the East Coast. She's wanting to hit a few baseball stadiums up there. So in the summer, we're going to go by and laugh at the Mutts. The Yankees are not in town the week we'll be there if we survive getting out of that place, as crazy as it is right now. So we're going to see the Mutts. We're going to take her to Fenway Park. And then we are going to end up catching a game in Montreal and do a few others. But while we're there, we were going to...
Who plays in Montreal now?
Fishing.
Who plays in Montreal anymore?
Or actually, in Toronto. I apologize, Toronto.
Oh, Toronto. Oh, yeah, Toronto. That'll be a nice stadium. I've been there. I've been to Yankee Stadium. I haven't been to Fenway. It's too bad that you're not hitting Camden Yards. I mean, Camden Yards is a to-do list thing. That's a bucket list thing for a sports fan. Camden Yards in Baltimore is where it all started in terms of building the old-style stadiums again. And Utah Street there, which is behind Wright Field, the food. Camden Yards is, what Truist Park was really built to be like. It's probably the closest thing to Truist Park that I've seen is Camden Yards. But Camden Yards is really special. And if you've never been to Baltimore, the Baltimore Harbor there is amazing.
We may try to add a day and see if we can throw that one in there, because we were going to leave from Boston and catch an Air Canada flight to Nova Scotia.
Wow.
Okay. And we were going to do Montreal and Toronto coming out of there, but I wanted to go to Nova Scotia and get a Nova Scotia lobster, one of the big ones. Mm-hmm. But while we were in Boston, we were doing this about over the course of about 9 days. I'm trying to find somebody. I wanted to go out on a fishing trip. So I was telling my wife, let's talk to Thom and see who he knows up there that we might can go out with.
Well, if you're talking about going offshore, well, actually I do have a guy. I don't know if Adrian Avena is still running charters. He was running charters, for Striper and stuff like that off of Long Island. And so I do have a guy. I'll check and get you his info. I'll find out if he's still running offshore charters or not. I've got a few guys that do, bass trips. But, if you're looking to go offshore.
Well, I started to go crazy and try to get a bluefin charter and just see. And then I took a look and I was like, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're talking $2,500, $3,000 a day.
Yeah, no, they can get nuts.
So just wanted to reach out there and say that, check your contacts. No, I'm proud of that guy. I'm proud of the people that they're not afraid to work for what they get, and they finally make it. And I hope somebody gives him a boat. Hope he gets a boat from somebody. They hook him up.
Well, he's got a sponsorship deal with Falcon, but he now has got his sponsorship lined up. I mean, the last couple of years, when he made the elites, when you make it to the elites, that's the top 100 fishermen in the world. When you make it to the elites, okay, the sponsors are there. But he's running a Falcon boat on a factory deal. Now he's not running a free boat, but he's running one where you get a really good deal, and then they sell it at the end of the year, and they'll make a profit on it and roll it into the next one. So he has a deep discount, a pro discount on a boat, but he has a rod deal with Halo Rods. He's gotten himself straightened out with it over the last couple of years, but this is life-changing. You know, winning the Bassmaster Classic is life-changing. It's like winning the Masters for a golfer, you know, when you win the Bassmaster Classic. It is life-changing.
Well, the people over at AL.com, they were wanting to anoint Bruce Pearl last week.
Yeah.
They're real quiet right now.
Yeah, I mean, they got a story in here.
He changed the SEC.
Yeah, he changed the SEC. They got a story in here about the, extensive story in here about the Troy, South Alabama baseball game that had probably 400 people at. But there's nothing in here. There's nothing in here about a kid who won $300,000. In front of 15,000
exactly.
people and millions of people, hundreds of thousands of people watching anyway around the world, right here, a hometown kid.
Well, if they won't talk about him, this show will. And before you go today, if you can get Grizz to play you that video of the NASCAR guy I sent you, if you need a good laugh before you go home, that was probably the best one I saw this weekend. And I don't know if it's air safe, probably not, but that is a good one. Guy complaining about the drivers and the cars, it is just total gold.
I'll have to check it out. Is it a spoof or is it real?
No, it's real. This guy.
Oh, it's something real.
I'm talking about. He is. I saw it when I was looking at the Kyle Busch video where he talked about all the '90s fans went away,
right?
And they didn't come back. That came up right after it, and that was just as good as what he was talking about. It was really funny because the guy does not like Kyle Larson at all, and it.
Yeah.
Cannot help but tell. But if you could sterilize a little bit of it and play it on the show, it'd be a good laugh. So,
right.
Roll Tide and catch them up.
Somebody tell Charles Barkley that it's the University of Alabama, not Alabama University.
He does that to Justin Thomas.
So he was doing it on purpose. Then.
Yeah, always messes with Justin Thomas. He even said it on the air.
Well, no, he said it on the air talking about Alabama's win over Grand Canyon. He called them Alabama University.
Right, because he said he always does it because he always messes with Justin Thomas. He says that's a thing between him and Justin Thomas. That's the reason why he says it like that. And then they literally tried to correct him, and he's like, that's the reason why I say it.
Oh, okay. Said Grand Canyon, that was the dumbest game of basketball I think I've ever seen. Everyone went one-on-one. They missed how many free throws? I'm not sure what they were doing offensively. I don't think they ran a play the entire second half. That was some of the dumbest basketball I've seen grown men play. Well.
It's like tackle basketball.
Yeah.
Used to play that in middle school.
Long as they went to the line a lot more times than Alabama did, that's for sure.
Yeah.
At least Alabama didn't lose to a bunch of, pocket protector, calculator carrying.
Leaders of the world.
Yeah. Yellies.
Leaders of the free world.
Jeez. Killing me. Let's get Vinny in here. Vinny, what's going on?
Tom, how are you?
I'm fantastic.
Grumpy's Bail Bonds, huh?
Grumpy's Bail Bonds was a sponsor of my show in Nashville. Yep.
Isn't that funny? Hey,
it may say something about my listenership, I think. I don't know why they felt they wanted to advertise on my show.
I wasn't gonna say anything. But if you want to, I know you have communication with Brandon. I'm from, where I'm from, Maine, New England. I can give him some names to contact if you want to. Okay, so if you want to forward my information to him, and he can text me or call me if he wants to. So, I might be able to help him out there.
Grizz,
so.
You got Vinny's phone number there popping up on your screen there. Write down his phone number so we can send it off to Brandon. Brandon, he can help Brandon out. I'm going to check Adrian Avina and see if he's still running Saltwater Charters as well. But go ahead.
Okay. When I moved here to Alabama in 2007, and we've won under Nick, Coach Saban, we won, what, 6-7 championships. And if I recall, okay, like 2 days after we won the national championship, we're thinking about what we have to do to win the next one, what we have to do. Okay, it's been 4 months, Thom, and we're still listening to the Michigan guys, and I'm not going to name anybody by name, but there's a couple of them still talking about a football game that happened 4 months ago. Am I wrong here?
No. Well, they're going to talk about it all the way until they are eliminated from playoff contention next year. I mean, they got themselves a national championship. It's different. You know what? I will say this. I mean, in 2010, when Alabama won the first one coming back, you know, under Nick. I mean, we pretty much talked about that all year long. Actually, we probably talked about that for a while. Then they got so many, I get confused as to what the years were. You know what I mean?
Natty times 12, Thom.
Yeah, okay. Exactly.
Oh, but anyway, and I was going to touch on what Barkley said about the game of basketball yesterday. But yeah. I thought it was entertaining, and I think that we won a dog fight, and that's something we had to do to prove to people we can win a dog fight. So, but anyway, that's my take.
Yeah, and they did. They won a grinder. Thanks for the call. I appreciate it. They did. They won a grinder. They won that kind of a game. It's not going to be that way with North Carolina. That was the only way Grand Canyon was going to stay in that game. Was it going to be that kind of a game? North Carolina game is going to be thoroughbreds. It'll be a little different looking deal. All right, we'll get a break, come back and close her up next right here on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Are you tired of power outages disrupting your life? It's time for a Generac standby generator from Current Electrical. Storms may rage outside, but inside your family's powered up. So why choose Current Electrical for your generator needs? One, we offer a wide range of models to suit every budget and energy requirement. Two, our project managers handle every step of the process. Power, gas, permitting, and inspections. Three, our certified technicians install your generator with precision, ensuring peace of mind. Don't wait for the next blackout. Call 256-880-1880 or visit us online at GenSuperstore.com.
Thom Luganbill here for my friends at Woody Anderson Ford. Bobby White and his team take great pride in their service department, and you can see it the moment you walk into those beautiful new service lanes. And just like a championship team, they all work together to make sure your experience is second to none, whether you drive a Ford or not. Also, check out the gold certified pre-owned inventory at Woody Anderson Ford for great deals every day. Stop by and see them at Jordan and Sparkman or at Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, or visit WoodyAndersonFord.com.
I'm attorney Gary Lackey. If you've been injured and need a lawyer right now, do you know who you really get?
I'm attorney Jennifer Lackey. You want to talk to your lawyer. My clients talk to me.
And me. I'm attorney Justin Lackey. We're the ones that you talk to.
And we're the ones who handle your personal injury case.
And we'll take care of it.
The Lackey Law Firm. 1-800-4-RIGHTS.
No representation is made that the quality of the legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other lawyers.
When I chose a garage door company, I did my homework. I needed Precision Overhead Garage Door Service. They have a 5-star Google rating. I checked the reviews and liked what their customers had to say. Precision Overhead Garage Door has lifetime warranty packages. Same day service if I call before 2 p.m. If they can't make it the same day, my service call fee the next day is waived. They did a 25-point safety inspection on the door and operator. Now that's peace of mind. Residential, commercial, and gate services. Precision Overhead Garage Door Service. Call 256-400-4500.
By now, you know about Eagle Masonry and Insulation, and maybe you know that Eagle also does landscaping and dirt work. But how about after paint work? Shower doors, shelving, and mirrors all taken care of by Eagle, the same Eagle that takes care of all your masonry, insulation, and landscaping needs. Eagle brings the same level of expertise to all these disciplines, and they're ready to provide you with a free quote. The website is the same, insulatewitheagle.com, as is the phone number, 256-755-1556. Give them a call and see what Eagle can do for you. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
Drivers who switch and save with Progressive could save hundreds, which could be life-changing. I mean, you could put that money towards that zero-turn lawnmower you've always wanted. And after using its edge-shaping technology to meticulously sculpt the face of the Mona Lisa into your grass, you'll become the undisputed king of Saturday morning lawn care, leaving your neighbor and sworn enemy Gary to question his place in the delicate neighborhood ecosystem. And it's all because you could save money switching at Progressive.com. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Not available in all states.
Two down, four to go.
Let's get out of here!
here and head to L.A.
It's the Crimson Tide and the North Carolina Tar Heels in the Sweet 16.
Oh, in the lane. Jump shot. Reverse layup. Good. Oh, the freshman growing up here.
Join us Thursday live from Crypto.com Arena in Los Angeles. Our coverage begins at 7:30 on your home for Alabama basketball. The Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
Online at 97.7ESPN.com.
Stream them online.
Call in.
It's an important job, and it's an vital organization.
Tweet in and join in. We are 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Bassmaster Radio, as we pull the Bassmaster Radio Phoenix Bassbo back to the dock, as we bring this one back to the dock, let's take a look at a couple of news and notes, or a couple of not news and notes from around the pond, but a couple of top of the hour texts and tweets. Let's see what I missed during the show. LSU Lynch says that I was at the Saturday game, so he was there for the Michigan goal. I thought he sounded like he was there. Maybe he was at both games. I thought he was at the Friday game, the way he was talking. But maybe he was at the Saturday game. Well, I guess he was. I would think that he knew which game he was at. From the 256, Grumpy slipped on by you, the driver he referenced. That's Max Verstappen, not Max Ball Slapping. Was that what he said? I'd have to go back and check. I'm not sure. I'll have to go check that one. Let's see. Harry says, Tom, please bring him on the show. This is worth the listen. The fishing equivalent of Rudy, well worth the time, and you could tell you're excited about the prospect. I am excited about it, and you know what? That's good. It is kind of a Rudy deal. I mean, he didn't sleep in the basement of the stadium, but almost. But he didn't just get in for one play. This dude is one of the top pros in the world right now.
I thought I saw he like 17 top 30 finishes, and he's got a top third finish, and you know he won that one.
Yeah, he finished fourth in the Classic in 2020. Missed the Classic in 2023. It's hard to make the Classic.
Yeah,
and then he won the Classic. He's got like 600,000 winnings now. Yeah, I reached out to him for Wednesday. And somebody called the text window. It's not a full show unless somebody calls the text window. Remember, you text the text window. About the Auburn loss, winning the SEC tournament had zero to do with it. Did playing 4 or 5 days in a row, I think it was five, did that hurt NC State? 18 and 19-year-olds don't get tired unless the coach runs them into the ground practice day after day. It had nothing to do with it. All right, I'm done. Coming up next, the Paul Feinbaum Show on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
No payments for 90 days on 23 and 24 models. Financing as low as 0%, and the best deals of the year on America's best-selling truck for 47 years in a row. Hi, folks. Bobby White back again for Woody Anderson Ford, and I'm here to tell you it's truck month. The best deals on F-150, Explorer, Bronco, Edge, Bronco Sport, and Escape. During truck month, get financing as low as 1.9% for up to 72 months on 2023 F-150 Crew Cab, and lease payments as low as $375 a month. That's a 36-month lease with $6,282 due at signing, zero security deposit, just tax, tag, title, and your good credit. Offer ends 4/2/24. Call 539-9441 for complete details. At Woody Anderson Ford, we have over 40 Bronco Sports and nearly 50 Explorers and about a dozen full-size Broncos, all with great sales incentives and no payment for 90 days. Truck Month only happens once a year. Woody Anderson Ford, hope to see you soon.
WZZN, Union Grove, Huntsville, Alabama. 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
The best in local sports talk from the 256. We are local.
When you're number one, you don't have to worry.
We are award-winning. Thank you for listening. 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
You'll be set for life.
Take it down. Hotty toddy, who's it gonna be? Cowbells and swamp. The egg is wrong. There's nothing like the SEC.
Are hard to stop. War eagles soaring in the wind.
Let me talk, Tammy.
Okay, go.
Tigers rocking in Missoula. Wildcats are grinning too. Talk about the tide that's rolling in. The weekend's full of surprises.
How you doing here, Bob? I might call you 2345 pass for the day over.
And welcome to the Paul Feinbaum Show. Yes, today is March 25th, 2024, and I am your host for today. So yes, Roman Harper is hosting today. Sorry to say it, you're going to be able to call Paul. No, you're not going to call Saul. No, you're going to call Roman today. So looking forward to it, and we're not going to wait any longer. We're kicking this thing off right now. We got a huge guest for us to kick off the Paul Feinbaum Show today, and that is head coach of the Texas A&M Aggies, Mike Elko. How about that? Coach, thank you so much for joining me today. I know you've been waiting a little bit while, you know. How are the vibes in Aggieland right now? Spring training starting to kick up. What are the vibes like in with Texas A&M right now?
Yeah, I think the vibes are great right now. I think we kicked off spring ball on Friday. I think finally getting out on the grass with our guys was great. I think getting to play some football, starting to implement our scheme, our philosophy. You know, that's what we do this for. You know, and it's funny when you take over these jobs, you go so long before you finally actually just get to go out and coach these kids and play some football with them. So it was an exciting time this weekend.
Now, Coach, two quick questions. All right. Number one, I haven't played in a long time. So when do we get to put the pads on? How many days do we go in spring before we get to put the pads on? And number two, I don't know if you can see this, but we're talking about the vibes. You guys, what's up with this whole, you know, rocking thing when you guys, when you first accept the job, you're rocking back and forth. How does this go about? How do you find this tradition yourself? There it is. We got a little picture.
There we go.
Our viewers awesome. Watching. What is up with that, Coach? Tell me about that.
Yeah, I said, so from that perspective, I think Texas A&M is such a special place with its tradition and its passion. And when we were here last time, we were fortunate enough to get a real good feel of what game day looks like. And so you get up on that stage, and that's the Aggie War Hymn, and you know the band starts playing, and the people start swaying, and that's what makes 105,000 people come to life in Kyle Field every Saturday. And so that's just a special part of what we do down here in Aggie Land, and certainly something we're really excited about. And then in terms of spring ball, you know, you wouldn't even recognize football anymore the way it's set up. We don't get to put pads on. We don't get to hit anymore. We don't get to tackle. We might as well just play two-hand touch anymore. But, no, we're helmets the last 2 days. We'll get full pads tomorrow when we go back out in the field and, you know, hopefully kind of crank up the intensity a little bit this week.
I mean, I would pay money almost to get into some kind of bull in the ring drill, some kind of drill where I get it just to put the helmet back on one more time. It's okay though. I'll let you guys handle that. But Coach, I want to know another perspective that a lot of the Aggie fans are wanting to know about, and we want to get our first view of this spring will be, and that is the offense under the new OC Colin Klein. What has that process been like for your team? And also, what is this offense going to look like as compared to what it was last year?
Yeah, I think, you know, comparing it, I don't know. I know what we're going to do. We want to be able to attack people. And I think that's one of the things that we talk about a lot is how are we going to put pressure on the defense? And people want to tie these offensive packages up into these cute little bows of, you know, spread or pro style or whatever. But I think what we want to be able to do is we want to be able to change and dictate tempo. We want to be able to move our personnel around so that we can put people on the matchups and in the areas that we want them to be. And we want to be able to attack and put a lot of pressure on opposing defenses. And I think as you build that, you know, a big part of that is finally getting out and working with your guys, because, you know, until you actually get hands on with them, see what they can do, see what their strengths are, see how they can attack people, it's hard to really, you know, you're just doing X's and O's on a board. We want it to be a little bit more specific to who our players are, what their skill sets are, and how we can truly take advantage of what we have.
I love what I'm hearing out of you, talking about really the one-on-one matchups, and understand that that's all really football is. When you got the matchup that you want, you go for those things. And what you bring back a quarterback with a lot of experience in Connor Wegman. I would like to know personally, how much playing time are we looking to anticipate? I know he finished the year last year with an injury. So coming off that injury, what are we looking like playing time for him? We're going to try and slowly walk him back in, get him more comfortable. I know you want to get him acclimated with some of the new play calls and things of that nature. But you also, I'm hearing, have a nice quarterback battle in behind him as well between Marcel Reed and Jalen Henderson.
Yeah, so obviously Connor comes in the spring as our number one, and I think everyone's aware of that. But, you know, like everything, you want competition, and you want competition within your program. And so, you know, Connor's out there now. He's back. He's taking the majority of the reps. He's not, you know, 100% back off that injury, but he's enough to go out there and do the things that he's got to do to start learning this offense and progressing how he wants to progress. And then, you know, you've got two quarterbacks last year who filled in and had some very successful moments. Jalen Henderson on the back end of the year had a great game against Mississippi State, leading us to a victory. And then Jalen winds up getting hurt on the first series of the bowl game, and Marcel Reed, as a true freshman, steps in and he throws for over 370 yards in the bowl game. And so you do have these two talented kids that are competing every day. And, you know, I think our job as coaches is to kind of make competition a backbone of what we are as a program. And so, you know, giving those two young men opportunities to kind of showcase themselves. And, you know, at the end of the day, I think everybody knows who the best player is coming out of spring, and that'll be the guy we line up with against Notre Dame.
You know, Coach, now that I got you here and you said something, it just really resonates to me. You talk about the competition and making competition your backbone of your program. I love that, right? Competition is what brings out the best in everybody. I love when I get to compete. That's why I love doing what I did for so long. But in today's time, when you push kids and make them want to compete and understand that competition is what we're going to do, a lot of these, some people, tuck tail and run. How do you continue to keep it competitive but still maintain the roster and also wanting guys to still be a part of them, that right here in Aggie Land, that we're still adding value to you no matter whether you're a starter or not? The competition is will be the result of what it is, but still staying here in today's time, we get the transfer portal.
Yeah, I just think you have to be honest and you have to be open with kids when you talk to them. And I think for the history of time, competition drives people to become what they're capable of becoming. Nobody gets to their best ability without a little bit of nervousness about having to be my best, or I'm not going to be able to continue to do what I do and what I love to do. And so, you know, listen, we don't shy away from this new era of college football. I think we embrace the opportunities that our players get. I think that's really awesome that they get NIL and they get to be involved in some of these things. But there's some core values that make a really good football team, and we're not going to shy away from that part of this. We're going to continue to develop men. We're going to continue to help them elevate to become what they're capable of becoming. And you know, hopefully we'll get known as the program who still does things the way they're supposed to be done in the game of football.
I like that. I like that. All right, Coach, now let's talk about – I want to talk about a receiver who really stood out to you guys last year, really came into his own, Noah Thomas, really made some flashes as a big-time receiver at times. How do we get him to be more consistently to where we saw the talent really flashed on tape, but how do we get that week in and week out? How are you guys talking to him about that and pushing him to be able to reach the potential that he has?
Yeah, I mean, listen, he's everything you want in a wide receiver. He's got a great catch radius. He's tall. He can get in and out of breaks. He can separate on people. And he certainly showed last year he's got an ability to go high point the ball and make plays. And I think, you know, as a program, we're trying to drive a higher level of consistency. And I think that starts with, you know, one, your offseason strength and conditioning. And I thought we had a great winter with Coach Tommy Moffitt and the different things that we did in that room and instilling some of those types of values into the program. And I think it continues with practice habits. And I think you become a consistent person when every single day you go out on the field, you play and prepare consistently. And I think that's, there's no secret to it. There's no shortcut. There's no secret sauce to how you become a consistent football player. You go out and you work. And that's, I think as a program, that's become our mentality this spring is we want to go out there. We want to enjoy getting on the grass together. We want to compete. And we want to become what we're capable of becoming, not only as individuals, but also as a program here for Texas A&M football.
All right, Coach, I want to we're going to get your way out of here on this one. I want to talk about fan excitement in Aggieland. Number one, how's it been now that you're the head coach of Texas A&M and also leading up to this season? I think we're going to show a schedule here about some of the games that are going to be coming up for you guys. And you guys, it's going to be a tough one. The SEC has continued to expand. You're staying at 8 games. But at all about the excitement of who all you guys are going to be facing. We got Arkansas. You're at Florida. I mean, starting off the season versus Notre Dame. Can we just talk about that excitement? What are the fans feeling? What are you hearing at Aggieland right now?
Yeah, listen, there's no program in the country that has a bigger fan base than Texas A&M, and there's
might
no
be right about
stadium that.
That
there's no stadium that rocks on Saturdays quite like Kyle Field. And so our excitement is at an all-time high. I think people are excited about the direction of this program. I think we have a tremendous fan base that's going to come out here this fall and get behind this team and be loud and be boisterous and be the 12th man that they've been for years. And I think when you look at the home slate, I think it lines up really good. I think we've got some really high-level games that are going to happen in College Station and Kyle Field this fall, and that's something not only our program's excited about, but you know these fans are going to show up in big time. And until you've been in Kyle on a Saturday night primetime kickoff, you know, you got a bucket list item you still got to check off.
Well, Coach, the bucket list item I got to check off is actually I got to go to Yale practice the day before the game. That's
there
what I
go.
Have to get done.
There
so,
you go.
Thank you for joining us on the Paul Feinbaum Show, Coach. I appreciate it with me personally, Roman. Nice talking, man. Appreciate that. Thanks for the insight, Coach.
Yeah, thanks, Roman. I appreciate you having me on.
All right, no doubt. All right, coming up next on the Paul Feinbaum Show, we got more and more guests coming. We got Kennington Lloyd Smith III. I heard he's a friend of mine. At 4, Phillip Dukes to cover a little bit of Auburn, so we get both sides of it, Alabama, Auburn, on everything. We got former coach, my homie and golf partner, Wimp Sanderson, coming in at 5:30 Eastern, and also Jason Marshall Jr., defensive back from Florida at 6. Looking forward to it. Many more guests and taking your calls all day long right here on the Paul Feinbaum Show.
With no fees or minimums and no overdraft fees, banking with Capital One is the easiest decision in the history of decisions. Even easier than choosing Charles Barkley in a pickup game.
We'll take Barkley.
Ha! First pick! Sorry, kids!
Yep, even easier than that. With no fees or minimums and no overdraft fees, is it even a decision?
Okay, here's the plan. Pass me the ball every time.
This is banking reimagined. What's in your wallet?
Terms apply. See CapitalOne.com/bank for details. Capital One N.A. member FDIC.
Did you know one of the best investments you can make? It's in yourself. At My Computer Career, in just a few months, you could start your new career in the high-demand, recession-resistant field of information technology. Isn't it time you invest in you and start a career in networking, cybersecurity, AI, or upskill to boost your current IT career? So, get the ROI you deserve at My Computer Career. No experience necessary. Start now at mycomputercareer.edu.
Financial aid is available for qualified students, including the GI Bill.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
When you call most roofing companies, all you'll hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming. At Fleming Roofing and Restoration, we're focused on your needs, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement. Folks around here have trusted Fleming since 1965 for all their residential and commercial roofing needs. And as the area's storm damage experts, Fleming knows all the ins and outs of the insurance claims process. Log on FlemingHSV.com to schedule your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration. We show up.
No payments for 90 days on 23 and 24 models. Financing as low as 0%, and the best deals of the year on America's best-selling truck for 47 years in a row. Hi, folks. Bobby White back again for Woody Anderson Ford, and I'm here to tell you it's Truck Month. The best deals on F-150, Explorer, Bronco, Edge, Bronco Sport, and Escape. During Truck Month, get financing as low as 1.9% for up to 72 months on 2023 F-150 Crew Cabs, and lease payments as low as $375 a month. That's a 36-month lease with $6,282 due at signing, zero security deposit, just tax, tag, title, and your good credit. Offer ends 4/2/24. Call 539-9441 for complete details. At Woody Anderson Ford, we have over 40 Bronco Sports and nearly 50 Explorers and about a dozen full-size Broncos, all with great sales incentives and no payment for 90 days. Truck Month only happens once a year. Woody Anderson Ford, hope to see you soon.
The state's largest orthopedic group is growing to meet the needs of the patients in our community. The Orthopedic Center has long been the most trusted name in orthopedics in North Alabama. So as our area continues on the fast track, so does the need for premier orthopedic care anywhere and anytime you need it. TOC is proud to announce the opening of our new locations in Albertville and Hampton Cove, along with the grand opening of our newest office in Decatur. These clinics will offer the same high-quality orthopedic care you have come to associate with TOC, with the convenience of being closer to home. As a patient, your time is your most precious asset, and we recognize that at TOC. That's why we are also proud to announce the opening of our urgent ortho clinics to handle those bumps and bruises that need prompt attention. These clinics are available to care for acute orthopedic injuries with no appointment necessary. With 38 physicians, 20 centers of excellence, and now more than a dozen locations to serve you, TOC will continue to be the name you turn to for the best orthopedic care at the right time. Visit our website at visittoc.com for more information. TOC, helping you live a better life.
What if I told you that Bigfoot is real and that he's making the best donuts you've ever had? Come see for yourself at Bigfoot's Little Donuts. Come in and order from over 50 flavors, all made hot and delicious. Ranked in the top 100 donut shops in the nation by Yelp. Bigfoot Little Donuts. Order in store or online at BigfootsLittleDonuts.com for pickup or delivery from Grub South or DoorDash. South Parkway, Huntsville and County Line Road, Madison. Bigfoot's Little Donuts.
Baseball's back, baby.
Olsen drills one deep right. You in trouble now. Way out of here.
Swung on, lifted high and deep to left center field. Go ball. Back to the wall. Jokes, that ball is gone. Home run, Ozzie.
Strider brings it. Got him swinging. Strike three. Number 13 in the book for Spencer Strider. Ronald Acuna drives one to deep center field. Deepest part of the yard. Way out of the ballpark. My goodness. Hit the batter's eye. That is some King Kong stuff from Ronald Acuna. High fly ball to deep center field. Back to the wall. Cold-blooded. Michael Harris. Swung on. Belton. Deep right field. Get out of here, Ozzie. Home run. Ball game.
Listen to Atlanta Braves baseball all season long. Right here on 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Thank you for making us your number one choice for sports talk in North Alabama.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you very much.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Welcome back on the Paul Feinbaum Show. I'm your host for the day, Roman Harper. Thank you so much. Now, let's just get to the headlines coming in off a crazy weekend. Number one, Georgia running back Trevor Etienne booked on DUI and three other charges. Once again, Trevor Etienne booked on DUI. Once again, Georgia's in the headlines for the wrong reasons. We don't like it, but we got to talk about it. Vanderbilt to hire James Madison's Mark Byington. How about that? You just get put out of the tournament. You already got a job waiting on you. Shout out to him. Congratulations for becoming Vanderbilt's newest and latest basketball coach. Can't wait to talk to you, Coach Byington. Now, Before we get to the calls, I would like to say, I think it is one other third headline, and that is Kim Mulkey firing shots all over the place this past couple days to the WAPO. Whoever this person is, nobody even knew that this was a scandal or a hit piece, as she called it, until she brought it all out. And now, literally, we're all sitting back waiting to see what the next move will be in this chess piece, this chess game of Coach Mulkey versus whoever she's talking about at the Washington Post. Now, let's get to calls. Swamp Dog in Georgia, welcome to the Paul Feinbaum Show.
Hello, Mr. Roman Harper. How you doing?
I'm doing good, Swamp Dog. I wish you had a name like yours.
Yeah, well, I like yours. You're one of the best analysts in the sport, in my opinion. And I got a good question for you because I know you played the game. This hip drop tackle thing that the NFL has come up with, what in the world does that mean? You can't leave your feet. You unweighted yourself. Have you ever even heard terms like this before?
Well, look, first and foremost, they are making – Swamp Dog, this is a great question. We talked about this before this show that, hey, it just got brought up. It just got passed by the NFL. For those that don't know, it is a hip drop tackle. That is the technical term that's never been used in a defensive meeting ever before. Half the time when these tackles happen, it's literally I'm just trying to get the guy down. I have no idea how they anticipate – NFL players playing defense going forward. Not only that, but the worst part of this whole deal and situation is that not only will I cost my team 15 yards for a personal foul, not only could I possibly hurt somebody, which I'm not even intentionally trying to do, I'm actually just trying to get this guy down because that I'm tackling that's usually bigger than the defensive player that's trying to tackle them, but I will get fined by the NFL on top of it. That is the worst part about it. Every time we get to another offseason, it's another rule implemented to give the offense an advantage in the game of the NFL right now, every single year. And not only that, but now we're taking money out of the defensive players' pockets by attempting to try to play the game at the highest speed, at the highest rate of speed as we know to do. So, Swamp Dog, I don't have the answers, bro. It makes zero sense to me. I'm completely against it, nor is it taught.
And how what they also do is put more judgment on the officials to decide when it happens. And they already got enough problems with that, you know, and how can they determine whether that's the call or not? You know,
Swamp Dog, I think all they do is this. All right, we'll get it out of here. We'll get you out of here on this one, my boy. Is the NFL, the more they are talked about, it's like the happier they are. And any kind of controversy on a Monday or a Tuesday after the Monday night only gets us talking about it Tuesday, Wednesday to get us to Thursday. And so you're right. It's going to put more onus on the refs to get this call right. And now we're only going to talk about is, well, why didn't they get that one right? And why didn't they didn't get this one right? Instead of let us just play ball and maybe you protect the quarterback from doing this. But then I also don't know how – because they already said you can't land on the quarterback. So now I'm trying to pull him back and fall a certain way. I just don't do it. I don't have no idea. I'm glad I'm not playing right now because I would be dead broke. Thank you. Thank you, Swamp Dog. Appreciate it. Slammer, right. You are the next caller on the Paul Feinbaum Show. I am Roman Harper. How you doing, boss?
Roman Harper, what's going on, man?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm okay. Where's Paul at? I was looking for him on the radio today, but I'm glad he got a little relief because I think he got too much heat from the Slammer.
Well, Slammer, you chased him away to Austin. Don't go find him, but he's in Austin. Don't worry about it.
Oh, he's in Austin. Okay, ain't far because I know the Crimson Tide's in Carolina.
Yes.
What do you think about that, Roman?
Number one, I don't doubt Nate Oates in Alabama's basketball team. Nate Oates has done an amazing job at continuing to push – continue to change the mindset and what Alabama believes that they can be in basketball on that campus. So that's number one. Number two, I didn't anticipate them doing it the way that they did it in the second round versus Grand Canyon. And that is they did it on the defensive side first. Mark Sears everybody putting pressure on the ball, doing a great job. Alabama does not win games defensively. Not this year. They have not been that team. But they did it this year in a different way. And so when you start to see teams evolve this late in the season, where now they're showing you that, hey, we not only can we win by being the team that we are, which is shooting threes, scoring 100, 80, 90-something points, but now we can actually win a game in the 60s where we keep another team in the 50s, but a lower scoring game in that type of fashion. I really give Alabama a lot of credit for that. Now they're going to have their hands full in the Sweet 16 versus number one seed UConn, who's returning all the playmakers that they have, R.J. Davis, Armando Bacot, all these other guys. It's going to be a really tough matchup. But Alabama, we all know, once they get hot, they are a tough team to stop. And if they can put pressure, just enough pressure, somebody gets foul trouble, anything like that can happen in these tournaments. That is what makes them so special.
I agree with you, Roman. I agree with you. Have you talked with Jim or Legend? Have you talked with them yet today?
They have not come on, Slammer, but I will make sure I tell them that you asked about them first. They're already getting shout-outs. What you want me to tell them? You want me to pass a message?
You tell them not to be too hard on your, because the Slammer's got you back.
Okay, deal. I'll take it. All right, I'll take it off of that.
Let me tell you what I think about you already. I hadn't heard you on here much, but I know who you are. But I think you're real close to being as good as Steve Smith. Steve.
I'll take that, man. Smitty's my boy, so I'll take that. Anytime I can get compared to greatness. Thank you so much, Slammer. Appreciate it, man. Thank you so much for calling in. Dwayne from Louisiana. You're on the Paul Feinbaum Show.
I'm from New Orleans.
Oh, the N.O., the 504, baby.
I'm
the
from
boot.
The N.O., uptown,
come on.
Third Ward.
You from the uptown,
right from
okay.
Right down to Magnolia Projects, baby. You know what I'm saying?
I do.
You know where that's at. Don't act like you don't know.
I do. I do. I still got a place there, so I'm there.
Street hustle. You know what time it is. Huh? Bottom line. Club. Well, damn all the clubs you want to hang out at. All that matter and killer and all that. Hey, Roman Harper, I got a question, baby. That dude from Purdue, man. How long that dude been in college, man?
Edney, I believe he is Zach Edey. He is the
man,
two-time.
How long that big dude been in college, man?
Actually, I think it's just 4 years. I think
that
he's
bullcrap. He can't go pro.
He is
seven,
a senior.
7'6".
He's 7'4", 300 pounds. Now, he's a senior because pro prospects and scouts say that he doesn't have a guaranteed professional career. So he's staying back
in
college.
Can you believe that?
I have no idea. I'm not one of those scouts. I'm not one of those scouts, Dwayne. So I'm just telling you what the people are telling me. That's what I do on Paul Feinbaum Show. I just repeat and report to the people. All right?
Dogging them dudes off, man.
Yes, and so they're saying he can't do that in the NBA. So that is why he's staying in college, getting a little bit of NIL money, perfecting his game to maybe go have to play overseas somewhere. Not in the NBA today. They're saying that's not what they're looking for. Zach Edey's been a monster. National Player of the Year. Back-to-back years, possibly, in the men's game. And they're saying, he's not good enough for the NBA.
What? You believe that, Harper?
Hey, I'm just here to report the news, Dwayne. You know I wouldn't lie to nobody from New Orleans. Come on, baby. You from uptown. Yeah. You think I lie to you?
I'm from uptown, baby.
You think I lie to you?
Third World Hustle. Huh?
I wouldn't lie to you,
What'd
man.
You say?
I wouldn't lie to you. No way. No
I know
way.
You ain't gonna lie to me, Harper. Hey, Harper, baby. I know what time it is. Cash Money, baby. You know what time it is, baby. Lil Wayne, Juvenile, BG. You know what time it is, baby. All right, Hustle. All right, Brahma Harper. Check you later, baby.
Thanks, Dwayne, man. Appreciate it, man. I already love it. People from New Orleans hitting me up. Third Ward, Uptown. I can't wait, man. This is gonna be an awesome day. We're just getting started. 30 minutes in. More when we come back on the Paul Feinbaum Show.
Texting enrolls you in recurring automated marketing text messages. Consent not required to purchase. Message and data rates may apply.
Leaving for the gym so early?
I'm ready to go.
Since you started taking Nugenix Total T, you've been acting like when we met in our 20s.
I feel like myself again. Lower testosterone after turning 40 slowed me down. Nugenix Total T has been a game changer for me.
What is it about Nugenix Total T that's different?
Well, it's a patented key ingredient called Testofen. It boosts free and total testosterone to help you get back the drive and energy from your youth. It's backed by 5 clinical studies.
I've seen the huge difference it's made for you in the gym, at work, and in the bedroom.
I'm so glad I sent them a text for my complimentary bottle. Text PREP to 321-321 right now for your complimentary bottle of Nugenix Total T. Nugenix is the number one selling testosterone boosting brand at GNC and Walmart. Do it now, and we'll also send you a bottle of Nugenix Thermo X, our newest, most powerful fat burner ever. Absolutely free. Text PREP to 321-321. That's PREP to 321-321.
97.7 ESPN The Zone. Listen to Talkin' Ball with Scott Tyson and Drew DeArmond.
Man, I appreciate what you guys do. I know Freddie Scott, Drew, Talkin' Ball 7 until 9 on my show when I feature Drew, and certainly have a great relationship with Wes and Steve and Thom and all you guys. Man, it's always fun to hang out with you with media days, different bowl events, but I always appreciate the partnership. I almost feel like we're sister stations with 97.7 The Zone, the only sports station in the Rockets. And thank you so much.
Every weekday morning, wake up with Scott and Drew. It's Talkin' Ball on 97.7 The Zone.
No payments for 90 days on 23 and 24 models. Financing as low as 0%, and the best deals of the year on America's best-selling truck for 47 years in a row. Hi, folks. Bobby White back again for Woody Anderson Ford, and I'm here to tell you it's Truck Month. The best deals on F-150, Explorer, Bronco, Edge, Bronco Sport, and Escape. During Truck Month, get financing as low as 1.9% for up to 72 months on 2023 F-150 Crew Cab, and lease payments as low as $375 a month. That's a 36-month lease with $6,282 due at signing, zero security deposit, just tax, tag, title, and your good credit. Offer ends 4/2/24. Call 539-9441 for complete details. At Woody Anderson Ford, we have over 40 Bronco Sports and nearly 50 Explorers and about a dozen full-size Broncos, all with great sales incentives and no payment for 90 days. Truck Month only happens once a year. Woody Anderson Ford, hope to see you soon.
Hey folks, Bob Baumhauer here. We're extremely proud that Baumhauer's Victory Grill has been serving Alabama for 43 legendary years. Our motto is legendary fun, legendary food, and we strive to make every dining experience a special one for all of our guests. Our menu features delicious, always fresh, and scratch-made in-house recipes. And of course, our award-winning wings and sauces. And don't forget, our happy hour and halftime daily specials cannot be beat. Baumhauer's Victory Grill, legendary fun, legendary food.
Two down, four to go.
Let's get out of here and head to L.A.
It's the Crimson Tide and the North Carolina Tar Heels in the Sweet 16.
Oh, in the lane, jump shot, reverse layup, good. Oh, the freshmen growing up here.
Join us Thursday, live from Crypto.com Arena in Los Angeles. Our coverage begins at 7:30 on your home for Alabama basketball. The Crimson Tide Sports Network from Learfield.
This is Brent Musburger's VSiN Action Update on 97.7 ESPN The Zone. Unlike other credit cards that decline sports betting transactions or treat them as a cash advance, the GBank Visa Signature Card can load directly to your favorite sportsbook apps. G.bank/VSiN.
NCAA Men's Hoops this Thursday, Sweet 16 action. East Regional, 5th seed San Diego State battles top overall seed UConn. Defending champion Huskies favored by 9.5. San Diego State plus 400 on the money line. The over-under, 135.5. West Regional, 2nd seed Arizona is favored by 6.5 against 6th seed Clemson. The Tigers plus 230 on the money line, over-under, 151.5. East Regional, 2nd seed Iowa State by 2.5 against 3rd seed Illinois. West Region top seed North Carolina favored by 3.5 against 4th seed Alabama. Get the latest lines and more at vsin.com.
From the Fox 54 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Emily Owen. For this Monday night, expect rain and a few thunderstorms to develop mainly after midnight. We'll see low temperatures fall into the upper 50s for the overnight. We'll keep windy conditions in the forecast as well. We could see wind gusts as high as 45 miles per hour. Heading into your Tuesday, rain and a few thunderstorms going to be possible. High temperatures topping out in the upper 60s for the afternoon. I'm Fox 54 meteorologist Emily Owen on your home for ESPN Radio 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
This will turn journalism on its ear.
Watch our stream on WZZN-TV on Twitch and YouTube.
But you are the greatest hero in American history.
We are 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Welcome back to the Paul Feinbaum Show. And yes, it is not Paul Feinbaum. It is your boy, Roman Harper. I know Jamari didn't like that one. But anyways, taking your calls all day long. We have some guests in between the hours, this, that, and the other. But I am here to get a people what they want. And that is just the truth and honesty. And next, we have Bash from Boulder, Colorado. Bash, what's up, man? You're on the Feinbaum Show.
Mr. Roman Harper, it is an absolute honor. Thank you so much for taking my call. How are you doing today?
Hey, man, I'm blessed by you, man. Hey, look, it's an honor for you to be calling me, so thank you.
No, sir, I just want to tell you that I grew up in Prattville, Alabama, as a lifelong Alabama Crimson Tide fan since I was 7 years old. I started playing Prattville YMCA football when I was 10 years old in 2005. After I saw The Longest Yard with Adam Sandler, it took off from there. It was an absolute honor to grace your presence when I was that little, and to go all the way 18 years later is unbelievable, Roman. Thank you. I wanted to ask you a question about the current status of the safety position in the NFL. But before I do that, can I give you my top five safeties since Nick Saban has unfortunately retired this season to play under the Nick Saban era for the Alabama Crimson Tide and see if it meets the Roman Harper standards?
You know what? I love this conversation. I love rankings. Let's do it. Go ahead, Bash. And shout out to Prattville, too. I know y'all tuning in and back there in the 334. Go ahead, Bash.
That's still my area code. Never forget it. So, number one, obviously got to start with Roman Harper. You are the original. You are the standard, the gold standard. And if it just like if I was starting a running back rankings, all the great ones that have come in recent years, they all fall under number one, Mark Ingram. No matter Derrick Henry, Najee Harris, Josh Jacobs, Mark Ingram was the first, just like you. So number two, the most talented one that's come under the years under Nick Saban, Minkah Fitzpatrick.
I totally agree.
Number three and four, I got tied between the two Jacksons, Kareem Jackson and Eddie Jackson.
I like that. Kareem played more corner in college, but he has transitioned amazing. He has had the longest career of any of the defensive backs that came out under Nick Saban. So yes,
underneath the radar call.
Kareem, yes. Great job. Great call.
Number five, I had to either go between Landon Collins and HaHa Clinton Dix. I had to go with Landon Collins. I just think he's just a little bit better. He's just a little bit more skilled and just, unfortunately, just made the cut in my eyes. And obviously, Brian Branch and Jordan Battle are up there, too, with honorable mentions, but had to go with Landon. Now, speaking of Kareem Jackson, Roman, I wanted to ask you, going to my question about the safety position in the NFL, what did you think when my Denver Broncos cut Kareem Jackson and put him on the reserve list, and he was obviously picked up by his original team, the Houston Texans. And then later they cut one of the greatest safeties in NFL today, Justin Simmons. And currently we have a bunch of the top safeties in the league, like Justin Simmons, Eddie Jackson, and Jamal Adams, for example, that are still free agents that are at this point undesirable. And I want to ask you, do you think they are the defensive comparison of the running back position currently as it stands?
All right, just to answer all of that for you, Bash, I love, number one, where your mind is going. Number two, I would pick Landon Collins over HaHa just because Landon Collins got like 90-something million. So you always, if it makes dollars, it makes sense in my mind. So that's number one. And then when it comes
to New York Giants paid him.
Hey, it don't matter. He got paid broke off. And that was with the Washington 100%. Commanders before – they changed their name to the Commanders. That might have been the football team at the time. But Landon Collins, and then when it comes to the safety position right now, you see all these guys being released and all these other things. The one thing I was told by the vets when I first got in the NFL is, Bash, the longer you're around this game, the less sometimes that it makes sense. That you're going to see crazier things than you could ever imagine. Really good players getting released, them keeping bad players. And a lot of times it has to do with the money. And so once you start to once they put your cap mark at a certain place and all of a sudden they're not getting a certain amount of production that they want or deem that you should be doing, you give them an opportunity to release you. And that's all it is. They always want to reset the market, and they always feel that they can get a safety at a different type of value, whether it's drafting a second-round guy, drafting a third-round guy, and maybe starting him or getting ready to start him. And so that's what it really comes down to. Jamal Adams is because of injuries. That's why he's on the streets right now. They actually released the other safety as well. So, and Justin Simmons is a great playmaker, a really good interception guy, has made a lot of plays in the league. But every now and then, this is what happens to all of the great ones. I bet Justin Simmons is getting closer to 30. That's another type of tail mark as well. So all these things start to figure out. I remember I was 29. The moment I hit 30, they're like, oh, you're about to get old. You must be old. I'm like, dude,
Jesus.
I look at every other part in the world. I'm just a young, debonair guy right here, 30 years old. Got the whole life, my whole life in front of me. But in NFL terms, you are starting to get over the hill. Bash, man, thank you for allowing us to get into that great mind of yourself. And also shout out to all the great safeties out there doing work, because we affect the game way more than any other star corner. A 100%. Star corner may affect the game in 20-something plays. A great safety affects the game with 60 to 70 plays because of the communication, the tackling, the pass defensive, and also the effect on the run game and everything else. So you're talking about a quarterback of the defense. Bash, shout out to you, bro. Next, we're going to Trav from Lexington, Kentucky.
Roman?
Yes, I'm right here, Trav. What's good?
Awesome, dude. So, look, I want to talk about John Calipari.
All right. I think I know something.
You know, guy, you know, like he gets up and he just apologizes for the way his players play all the time. And I'm sick of it. I'm a graduate there. And, look, did we have a good team? Of course we did. But I'm sick of him piling on the players. You know? Do you all have a comment on that or anything?
Not exactly. I do know this. It starts at the top. It starts at the top. And so you know, especially when you have younger players that you're going to be depending on. But this is how Calipari and Kentucky are built. They are built for the now. They
I
are
know,
built
look,
with the young players.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No. You're fine. It's okay. I'm here to listen to you, Trav.
I'm not the one that's mad. Is this method broken where it can't work anymore? Like, you know, we got the NIL and, you know, transfer portal and all that. And he's like, well, we got 18-year-olds playing out here against 25-year-olds. They're playing against grown-ass men.
And Trav, he's not wrong about that. But you also got to understand, when it comes to Kentucky basketball, NIL is not a problem. Never been a problem. Not saying anything.
No, never been
a problem. And it's also, this is what Calipari's always done. He's always going out and get the top-tier players year in and year out. And when you guys have the right mix.
We had Antonio Reeves this year. Without him, what would we have done? Right?
Yes, correct. And it's also, you guys have to get the right mixture or combination. And in today's men's NCAA basketball, the older teams are winning. Look at San Diego State, for example, last year.
Nobody paid
attention that they had 25, 24, 23-year-old players all over the roster. That matters in these times, in today's NCAA basketball.
I agree 100%. So let me ask you a question.
Yes.
It's the last question I got here. I know you only have limited time. But is Calipari the right fit going forward for the next 10 years?
Now, Trav, I mean, I can't tell you what I think's right in the next 10 days. So, I don't know.
ESPN Radio, 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
You know, this process is all about talking ball.
Listen to Talkin' Ball with Scott Tyson and Drew DeArmond.
What did they want privacy for? To just start talking ball.
Every weekday morning, wake up with Scott and Drew. It's Talkin' Ball, 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Welcome back. The Paul Feinbaum Show. I'm your host today, Roman Harper. And we are getting straight to the calls right before we get to another break here. So let's keep it rolling. Almost done through the first hour. This is rolling through. We have Todd in Shelby. Welcome to the Feinbaum Show. You're talking to Roman Harper. What's good, man?
Hey, thank you, Roman. Looking good, babe, brother.
Thank you, brother. I appreciate
it. I don't know much about stuff as bad as this. I just called in this show to aggravate the hell out of somebody. This is what I want to know. It's two or three things I want to talk about. But did them Goat Humpers get beat by an Ivy League team being Yale? Ain't they an Ivy League team, Roman?
That is correct.
Okay, so they done whooped the Goat Humpers from the Plains. All right, one more thing I done heard this morning. Georgia, they finally got ahead of us, and then we put them back in their place. And when they beat us for the national championship that year, I called in and told that we didn't really know how to suck quite as good as Georgia. And we got it straightened out, and we whipped Georgia. But when we did and went into the playoffs and played Michigan, everybody in the United States said, no, Georgia would be the better team in. But we won ourselves in, and we ended up one of the top four. All right. Since we're in the Sweet 16, Roman, don't that make us better than Auburn?
Technically, yes, it does. You are correct.
I look at it.
Todd, and I know Auburn won the SEC tournament. Some are going to complain because they had to go out to Spokane to play in that side of the bracket. They were a four team in the SEC tournament. They win the SEC, and they still are a four team, four seed behind 2 and 3 of Kentucky and other brackets. Yeah. It don't matter. They're all at home now. They're all at home. Alabama's the only one there.
Yeah. All right, let me hit Georgia big time right now. Kirby Smart's done let something get loose over there. Now, I called in and told Paul, there ain't nobody in the world named as NEM or whatever it is that just got in trouble with the DUI, that they heard that NEM on the Wizard of Oz, NEM Dorothy's 8, and that's where they got that name. Ain't nobody named that. And the only way that Georgia is going to keep them players wrapped up is take all the alcohol out of Georgia, because they're going to have to go to Cat Daddy in South Carolina to get it. Hey, Roman, thank you for taking my call, buddy. Roll Tide, man.
Roll Tide, Todd. All right, we're going to get one more quick call in here before we get y'all out of here. Actually, you know what? I'm just going to talk about what Todd was talking about. You know what? Let's just talk about it. All right. I'm not here to beat up on Auburn fans, but Auburn fans, you should be disappointed, okay? That basketball, you're supposed to beat Yale, period. You had too good of a season, too great of a finish to the season to not continue to punch tickets and move on. Trust me, you were picked in my bracket. You disappointed me as well. So it's not just the Auburn faithful that should be disappointed, and you're allowing people like Todd to continue to poke the bear and say how they're better than you. When, look, let's just be honest and truthful. Alabama was not better than Auburn basketball this year. But the way you finish is how you will be remembered. And this is another lesson for all of us to be learned today. So we'll continue to go forward. And Roll Tide it is. Yeah, I hear that in my ear. But, yes, Auburn, you have to be better. You got to win that game versus Yale. It doesn't matter where you play. It didn't matter when you guys were in Nashville, and I heard you guys after the game talking about the winning, that they did need to be at your home field, where Auburn has had a dominant performance all year long. So it would be really, really good for Auburn to continue to bounce back. And I want to hear more callers talk about it as well. Coming up next, one of the Alabama beat writers. Looking forward to him. Kennington Lloyd Smith III. Can't wait. Let's talk a little bit of ball about Alabama.
Hi, everyone. If you've been injured in an accident that was not your fault, listen up.
We have legal professionals standing by to answer your questions for free. Call now and find out if you have a case and how much it's potentially worth. Call 800-702-1010. I'm here with spokesman John Wolf. So, John, tell everyone listening who should call right now.
Well, Maria, first off, thank you for having me here. It's always nice to answer the listeners' questions. Now, as far as who should call in, anyone who's been injured in an accident and think you deserve compensation, give us a call right now. 800-702-1010. You'll find out if you have a case and how much it's potentially worth.
Thanks, John. You heard it, folks. Take advantage of this opportunity.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
The kitchen is the heart of any home. It's where the family gathers. It's where kids discover old recipes and make them their own. Just starting out or just now getting started on the dream kitchen you've always wanted?
I'm Chris Haygood, and from all of us here at Bob Wallace Appliance to the home builders and the homeowners of the Huntsville area, a heartfelt thank you for buying local. We're in Huntsville, Florence, and Coleman, and online at bobwallaceappliance.com.
Electric cars are coming faster than you think, and that's why we're bringing SEMA Connect to Alabama.
Our team educates you and helps provide a long-term plan for your business. Where to put them, how to get them there, how to pay for them, tax incentives, service, and monitoring. We take care of everything.
Doing the right thing means bringing EV car chargers to Alabama. Let us help you with your EV charging plan.
Since 1986, Full Moon Barbecue has been cooking quality meats low and slow over a hickory wood-fired pit. From ribs and wings, brisket, turkey, catfish, and sausage to the best butts in town. If you're planning a holiday or a birthday party, Full Moon has a large banquet room. And Full Moon is ready for your next catering or tailgate. Just call us and we'll take care of everything. 256-713-0070. Full Moon Barbecue on the parkway next to Costco. The best little pork house in Alabama.
Did you know that Valley Equipment Rental also specializes in day and weekend rentals to homeowners? The weekend rentals is by far the best deal that they offer. If you pick up after 2 on a Friday or anytime Saturday morning, it's not due in until Monday morning before 8 a.m. for a one-day charge. For a small fee, Valley can even haul anything they carry. Valley has extremely experienced and knowledgeable staff that can help you decide what size machine you need or what type of machine you need to get your job done like a pro. They have all the big items that the contractor need for their jobs, but they also carry the small tools that can help you with your DIY project. More importantly, Valley is locally owned and operated, which means when you have an issue, you can get someone on it right away right here in the Valley. Heck, ask for Ross Roberts, the owner, if you like. Try calling one of the big box national outlets and ask for the owner. That's if you can even get through the automation. Buy local. Buy Valley Equipment Rental. Valley Equipment Rental has two locations, one on the North and South Parkway. Learn more at valleyequipmentrents.com.
The countdown to opening day is on, and the Atlanta Braves Radio Network is bringing you the biggest coverage from Florida as we gear up for the 2024 season. The Braves open the season Thursday the 28th on the road in Philadelphia as the hunt for a seventh straight division title begins. Then it's an epic home opener on Friday, April 5th against the Arizona Diamondbacks as Truist Park comes alive for Braves baseball.
Coach Nick Saban.
Helping children is very important to Miss Terry and me. As parents, it saddens us to know that there are more than 5,000 children in foster care in Alabama. These children need loving, nurturing families to care for them. We ask you to join the team and become champions for children by opening your heart, opening your home, and becoming a foster or adoptive parent.
For more information, call 1-866-4AL-KIDS. Sponsored by the Alabama Department of Human Resources, Alabama Broadcasters Association, and this station.
Cross someone offering to tell me what the longest word in the English language is, and I was like, I'm in on that.
It is 45 letters long, and it refers to a type of lung disease. It is called pneumono-ultramicroscopic silico-volcano-corneosis. I like everything about it. I like each of the individual words. Pneumono, I like ultra, microscopic is good, silico, volcano, and coniosis. Don't you think coniosis sounds like someone who would have had like a cup of coffee in the outfield for the Dodgers in the 40s? In the outfield there was Duke Snyder and Phil Coniosis.
Greeny with Mike Greenberg. Weekday mornings at 10 Eastern on ESPN Radio. Plus you can watch and listen on the
WZZN, Union Grove, Huntsville, Alabama.
Alabama!
Your home of the Crimson Tide Sports Network. This hour of the Paul Feinbaum Show is brought to you by the Huntsville International Airport and Breeze Airways. Everything you need is just a click away.
I should pop some time, Sue.
Okay, almost everything.
Come on, Bob. Tell your fortune.
Log on today, 97.7ESPN.com. 97.7ESPN, The Zone.
Hard to stop. War eagle
soaring in the wind. Let me talk, Tammy.
Okay, go. Tigers rocking in Missoula. Wildcats are grinning too. Talk about the tide that's rolling in. The weekend's full of surprises.
Big upsets to robberies. On the Farm Mom Show, heads are gone to roll. If they don't get the best of me, we'll call for
in my head when I wake up.
I might call you 2345 for the day away.
I'm your host today, Roman Harper, as Paul is sitting this one out, maybe getting an ice bath. Maybe he's just resting his legs, whatever he's doing from his long weekend. Good luck at whatever you're doing, Paul. Now, next up, we have our guest before we get back to more of your phone calls. Our next guest is Kennington Smith. How you doing, brother? I see some stuff in the background, man. I think you're a friend, huh?
Yeah, most definitely. I'm so glad that you asked. Just want to say, woo to all the good bros out there, the Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated, specifically the Bloodthirsty Beta Zeta chapter at the University of Georgia. But I am here in Tuscaloosa, so I got to give a shout out to Beta Eta as well. They've definitely been a friend to me since I've been here.
Man, there we go. Shout out, man. You know how the bros do, man. We're going to look out when we can. So that's all good and that's all well. I'm glad we were able to get over that and get to that. Tell me this. The recruiting at Alabama under Kalen DeBoer, it's been hot. It's been hotter than anticipated, maybe, possibly. But it's also maybe not at the same clip as Nick Saban. Could you maybe decipher that to not only myself, but to the fans as well? Where does Kalen DeBoer and this staff stand as they measure up against Nick Saban and what he was able to accomplish as far as the recruiting trail is concerned?
Yeah, to your point, Alabama's been red hot in the month of March. They've gotten six commitments this month, and I think it's kind of one of those cases where as time goes on, emotion is starting to fall by the wayside and logic is starting to creep in a little bit. Whenever Saban or somebody of his caliber steps away from the game, there's going to be a seismic impact. And there were a lot of players that were committed to Alabama that took a step back because they wanted to see who was going to be the head coach. And there are probably some players that folded their arms up and said, if Saban isn't coaching at Alabama, then I'm not going to consider it. But then as time goes on, you start to do more research on Kalen DeBoer and you start to learn about who he is and what he's been able to do. This is somebody who has won at a very high clip in the FBS, despite only being a coach for a few years. He's been to a national championship. If you are on the offensive side of the ball, it's hard to ignore what he's done on that side of the ball. So it's all about getting players on campus. And that's what he's been talking about since he's been, you know, doing availabilities during spring practices. The key is getting players back on campus. And when players get on campus and they still see the tradition at Alabama, they still see that, you know, the winning culture, they still see practice intensity, and then they get a chance to actually meet Kalen DeBoer, meet his assistants, and get to know them on a personal level, you start to think to yourself that Alabama is going to still be an elite program despite Nick Saban walking away. So I think that's kind of where the momentum is coming from, is just him being able to put his own stamp on an existing brand at Alabama. And as far as where Alabama sits in terms of the recruiting rankings, you know, depending on where you're looking at, they're a top five class, a top 10 class right now. And in some ways, it's probably a little unfair to expect him to recruit at the same level as Nick Saban. This is somebody who had 10 number one classes during his tenure at Alabama. I don't know if anybody's going to be able to match that level of recruiting over that period of time. But if Kalen DeBoer can stay a top five, top 10 recruiter, utilize the transfer portal, which he's done at Washington, and he has some recruiting staffers with expertise in that, and his level of coaching ability, being able to elevate talent, I think we saw that at Washington, then Alabama's going to be just fine.
All right, you know, and talking about getting the recruits on campus, I mean, have they seen the campus? It is beautiful, and everything that's there to offer as well. I want to stay with Kalen DeBoer here. What have you taken in from him as a coach of these type of players? I heard him at the pro day. All he talked about, all he wanted to talk about, and you heard the same thing repeated from some of the players, was building a relationship. That seemed a little bit different under Kalen DeBoer, that it was more I'm not saying it wasn't under Nick Saban, but that is what his bell cow. It was not about all the other things and X's and O's. Yes, that matters. But it's about the relationship that I'm able to build with each individual player. And then the football things will take care of itself.
Yeah, huge on relationships. And that's something that has been a consistent talking point since he's been, you know, here at Alabama. And I think it's kind of reverberated through the entire team. We've got a chance to talk to a lot of players since spring practice has started. And they've all just kind of talked about who he is as a person and how he's really just kind of wanted to establish that kind of personal connection, because it's tough for him to kind of come in and follow the legend of Saban and who he was in terms of his stature. And DeBoer is going to come in. He's been himself. And I think it takes a lot of confidence to come in and keep some things the same and not, you know, tear everything down and say that I'm going to, you know, be so completely different from Saban and implement, you know, everything that I had at different programs. I'm going to keep things that are important to the players, and I'm going to implement my own spin on top of that to continue this train rolling. And I think when you're talking about the relationship aspect, really sitting down and talking to the players that stayed and understanding what is important to them and who is important to them in the building, and keeping some of those guys on staff, like a Freddie Roach, for example, who is Alabama through and through, a Robert Gillespie, who's done a great job since he's been hired, you know, a couple of years ago, keeping the fourth quarter program in place, I think has made players really comfortable. And then when they see who he is as a football coach and the X's and O's and the success, it really kind of makes for a really nice blend. So obviously there's a long way to go, and what happens on the field is going to dictate a lot, but it's hard to really kind of poke holes in the first few months of Kalen DeBoer's era. And it seems like, you know, all indications from inside the program is that it's been a pretty smooth transition, and everybody in the building has full confidence in him.
All right. And I know you mentioned a couple of things. You talked about the staff, some of the hold-ons from the staff is kind of what the players wanted. You talked about the fourth quarter program, which, if you don't know what that is, that's just the off-season conditioning to make sure guys are competing and doing some other things. Could you name specifically anything that the players liked under Saban that Kalen DeBoer has said, you know what, we're going to keep that. That's what we will do as well.
Yeah, I think really the fourth quarter program was really the kind of the main thing, is something that the players spoke to at last season as something that was a really galvanizing force and made players closer in terms of having that brotherhood, you know, in terms of competing, which helps them on the field. That's a really big part of it. And as far as, you know, the holdovers in terms of Freddie Roach and Gillespie, those kind of guys, and some off the field staffers as well, the Josh Chapmans and the James Mosley's and those guys off the field. Ha-ha Clinton Dix also, I can't leave him out as well. So kind of keeping those players around the building, players who have played for Alabama and kind of know the standard and know what it's been over the last few years, just to have players comfortable. So I think those are kind of the main things. And, you know, defensively, I think is another thing as well. I know there's been a lot of talk about, you know, Kane Womack coming in and maybe changing the philosophy of Saban's defense. But in talking to him and talking to players, it seems like the defensive strategy is much more closer in terms of Saban's philosophies than maybe we anticipated going into spring practice. So those were a couple of holdovers in place that have kind of made those players comfortable. And I think the players have embraced Kalen DeBoer and what he's brought as well. And I think it's worth noting, and Tyler Booker said this when we talked to him a couple of weeks ago, that Washington made it farther than Alabama last year. So clearly what Kalen DeBoer is doing is working. That's not to say that he's a better coach than Nick Saban, but his way is proven. Fresno State, Washington, what he's done statistically on the field, player development, elevating a roster. Washington's talent composite is obviously not on the same level as Alabama's yet. Washington was a national championship contender last year. So when you blend those two things together, it's hard not to get excited about what the potential could be under him.
I mean, it makes all the sense in the world. Hey, first and foremost, shout out to my boy Freddie Roach, who was my college roommate. You know, we still represent class of 2001, still on that campus 22 years later, still helping out and continue to grow that program. I want to talk about Kane Womack. I saw him at spring, actually at the pro day last week. First and foremost, Kennington, it looked completely different. I saw coaches talking to other, doing interviews. It wasn't just one coach. Like, offensive coordinator got on some TV time. The defensive coordinator got some TV time. It was other different representatives. Could you maybe go into Kane Womack, what he's going to be able to do. I heard him talk about really not changing philosophy, but building this defense and what they're trying to do conceptually around their great players that they have that's already there defensively. And that really, instead of always playing press man-to-man coverage, it's more about vision on the quarterback. So now they can be more impactful in forcing more turnovers, in which they led the country 2 years ago at the University, or 3 years ago at the University of Indiana.
Yeah. In terms of Kane Womack, this is somebody who is one of the, not an originator of the 4-2-5 defense, that was his dad, but somebody who has really kind of taken it and made it his own and has been really successful. You bring up what he did at Indiana, at South Alabama. They were one of the better defenses in FBS last year. They were able to put pressure on the quarterback. They were able to get a lot of takeaways. And it's an aggressive style. And you're going to see players maybe playing different roles and doing different things and talking to some, particularly on the defensive line, and kind of in that outside linebacker group, being able to maybe drop in coverage more, show a little bit more of their skill set, but still being able to kind of have that emphasis on rushing the passer. So it's going to be a really aggressive defense. It seems like he's a really hands-on coach, and I think that it's really critical that, you know, him working with that inside linebacker room. You think about Alabama's defense and what was lost last year, and there was a lot of talent leaving, but what is returning, you think about that core group of Deontay Lawson and Jihad Campbell in the middle of the defense, having Womack really working closely with them to make sure that everybody on the defense is on one accord, because Deontay Lawson is going to be the one calling that defense. I think it's going to be really significant. So he brings a lot of energy, and what he's been able to do on the recruiting show, kind of circling back to that conversation, you see the amount of recruits they're getting on the defensive side of the ball, particularly at the linebacker position. His message is resonating on the recruiting trail, and it's been resonating on the team as well.
All right, Kington, I got one more quick one before I get you up out of here, bro. That is Jalen Milroe. We all know the story last year. Started off the season where nobody said he could play quarterback. Then all of a sudden he gets the nod under Nick Saban, benched after the Texas game, yada, yada, yada. We all know the story. This offseason, I haven't seen a college football player more looked at as a superstar. I mean, he's on college basketball. He's on, you know, everything going on. He's the man. He's grew his hair out a little bit more. He has the greatest smile. Can you talk about this man's maturity and what does he look forward to next year? And how are they accepting him, or what is he looking like? What is the future looking like for him right now?
Yeah, I mean, Jalen Milroe is a superstar, and anybody who has spent close time with him, whether it's from the Alabama side as a coach or a player, or myself on the media side and the interactions that I've had with him, this is somebody who just reverberates energy, positivity, always and consistently talking about wanting to get better and wanting to be the best that he can so the team can move forward. And when you're talking about his story and kind of his profile as a player, when you think about, you know, some legends of the game, the Michael Jordans, the Kobe Bryants, even the Jalen Hurts at Alabama, kind of what they've had to go through in their individual journeys in terms of Michael Jordan being left off the varsity team and coming back and being a great player, Kobe Bryant's work ethic, or Jalen Hurts being benched, coming back, helping Alabama win an SEC championship the next year. Now he's on to the NFL. Jalen Milroe's story kind of has a little bit of all of those things, and he kind of represents you know, somebody that you want to have representing your football program. And in terms of the steps that he's been able to take, I think that the fact that he was able to help lead Alabama to a championship last year in the SEC and lead them to the college football playoff and have the confidence in himself that maybe didn't exist early, you know, in the season, getting benched and going through those things. I think him coming back, having that confidence, knowing that he's the guy, and having the faith and the trust of Kalen DeBoer, Nick Sheridan, the offensive coaching staff. Every time that they come to the podium or they're in front of a microphone, they talk about the type of leader that Jalen Milroe is, the type of person that he is, the type of wanting to consistently improve, and how he's leading the offense. I think it's going to be really exciting to see what he looks like in Kalen DeBoer's offense, being a part of a Blaine Trust and DeBoer and Sheridan and Jamarcus Shepherd and the rest of the staff that are really going to accentuate his talents. And I think that's going to, you know, raise the entire profile of Alabama's offense. So looking ahead to this spring, obviously learning the playbook is going to be, you know, one big part of it. And I just expect Jalen Milroe to progress as a passer. I expect him to be utilized more in the running game, which is going to open things up for Alabama's offense. And I think it's going to be a really dynamic group. So you talk about somebody who is kind of coming into this year as a star player. I anticipate that Jalen Milroe is going to kind of get that press run that we've seen past Alabama quarterbacks or other star quarterbacks having college football of, you know, all SEC teams and Heisman hype and big profile stories and all of those things. And it's going to be really fun for the nation at large to kind of get a little bit more of his personality and learn more about him as the season approaches.
Hey, Kennington Smith, man, thank you so much for honoring us with your time, bro. I appreciate that, bro. I'll see you later, Rudolph. Man. Hey, Rudog, enjoy yourself. Enjoy the weekend. Thank you so much, Kennington Smith III. Your calls next on the Paul Feinbaum Show.
Texting enrolls you in recurring automated marketing text messages. Consent not required to purchase. Message and data rates may apply.
Leaving for the gym so early?
I'm ready to go.
Since you started taking Nugenix Total T, you've been acting like when we met in our 20s.
I feel like myself again. Lower testosterone after turning 40 slowed me down. Nugenix Total T has been a game changer for me.
What is it about Nugenix Total T that's different?
Well, it's a patented key ingredient called Testofen. It boosts free and total testosterone to help you get back the drive and energy from your youth. It's backed by 5 clinical studies.
I've seen the huge difference it's made for you in the gym, at work, and in the bedroom.
I'm so glad I sent them a text for my complimentary bottle. Text PREP to 321-321 right now for your complimentary bottle of Nugenix Total T. Nugenix is the number one selling testosterone-boosting brand at GNC and Walmart. Do it now, and we'll also send you a bottle of Nugenix Thermo X, our newest, most powerful fat burner ever. Absolutely free. Text PREP to 321-321. That's PREP to 321-321.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
In Tuscaloosa, we live by the blue-collar basketball motto.
Stepping back, deep three, bottom.
Hard work.
Two on one, driving, stepping through, tough shot, got it to go.
Teamwork.
Play the song for the champions of the Southeastern Conference.
Join us for every game right here on your home for Alabama basketball.
Listen to Alabama basketball all season long on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
You've got to experience Toyota-thon at Bill Penny Toyota. They've got the selection with over 700 new Toyotas to choose from. And they've got the extras with Bill Penny perks and a 10-year unlimited warranty. So get on over to Bill Penny Toyota today and experience Toyota-thon. Bill Penny Toyota in Huntsville and online at BillPennyToyota.com. Bill Penny's Toyota 10-year unlimited warranty is valid through the 10th year of ownership. Valid on new vehicles only. See dealer for details.
Football season and Bad Daddy's Burger Bar. The perfect combination of good times and great food. This season, score big with one of our chef-inspired expressions of pure burger amazingness. Our delicious burgers are made with premium Angus beef, and you can pair it with one of our signature cocktails or a cold craft beer from our huge selection, Bad Daddy's Burger Bar, on the Parkway in Huntsville and our new location at Cliff Farm, Highway 72 in Madison.
The kitchen is the heart of any home. It's where the family gathers. It's where kids discover old recipes and make them their own. Just starting out or just now getting started on the dream kitchen you've always wanted?
I'm Chris Haygood, and from all of us here at Bob Wallace Appliance to the home builders and the homeowners of the Huntsville area, a heartfelt thank you for buying local. We're in Huntsville, Florence, and Coleman, and online at BobWallaceAppliance.com.
Drivers who switch and save with Progressive could save hundreds, which could be life-changing. I mean, you could put that money towards that zero-turn lawnmower you've always wanted. And after using its edge-shaping technology to meticulously sculpt the face of the Mona Lisa into your grass, you'll become the undisputed king of Saturday morning lawn care, leaving your neighbor and sworn enemy Gary to question his place in the delicate neighborhood ecosystem. And it's all because you could save money switching at Progressive.com. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates, not available in all states.
AL cert number 21014.
Are those high utility bills driving you crazy this time of year? If they are, Talon Heating and Air has the special for you.
That's right. We're going to run a $49 spring checkup on your system. We're going to come out, we're going to check those heat kits, make sure that everything was working through the winter right, and then we're going to also make sure your Freon's good, make sure that you're ready for the summertime.
How important is that to be done this time of year?
It's really the most important time of the year. We can avoid safety concerns caused by wintertime use, and then we can also make sure that you're ready for the summertime.
And to get ready for the summertime, you just got to call?
256-503-4490.
Or you can find him online at
talenthvac.com.
That's Talent Heating and Air. One more time.
256-503-4490.
Talent Heating and Air. Let them save you money.
From the Fox 54 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Emily Owen. For this Monday night, expect rain and a few thunderstorms to develop mainly after midnight. We'll see low temperatures fall into the upper 50s for the overnight. We'll keep windy conditions in the forecast as well. We could see wind gusts as high as 45 miles per hour. Heading into your Tuesday, rain and a few thunderstorms going to be possible. High temperatures topping out in the upper 60s for the afternoon. I'm Fox 54 meteorologist Emily Owen on your home for ESPN Radio 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
The Drive with Wes Neighbors and Steve Moulton. Listen weekday afternoons starting at 5 on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
It's perfect!
Welcome back to the Paul Feinbaum Show. I'm your host for the day, Roman Harper. All right, man, let's get this thing going. Back to more of your calls. Great job by Kennington Smith from The Athletic, really letting us in on the insights of what's going on at the University of Alabama under Kalen DeBoer, this new regime, all the positivity, the good vibes. You know, let's just keep it rolling. But probably not with the next caller, and that is J.K. the Alabama hater. And I can't wait, JK. I'm here for you. What you got for me today?
What's up, big dog?
What's up, baby? I mean, you're not bringing in the heat. You good? You all right?
Man, I always got the heat, and I always want the smoke. I don't care if it's hookah, weed, chimney, mosquito rag. I want all the smoke.
Well, JK, lucky for you, I got my cigar right here for you, dog. Smoke engaged.
Hey, check it out. Hey, man. Every time you come on, I'm going to give you your props. Man, you cleaner than public supermarket. Not the Board of Health. You cleaner than Publix. Hey, Roma, check this out, man. I want to get your opinion. Since we just got the normal Alabama report, what's your prediction on Alabama's football season this year?
All right, let's bring up the schedule. Can we bring the schedule up for me? JK, I'll be honest with you. Alabama has lost two games three out of the last 4 years. And people thought the sky was falling. You heard them all. But let's look at it. Let's go through it. Western Kentucky. Can we agree? Win?
Yeah.
South Florida. Win? At Wisconsin. Oh, you don't know.
Hold on. Now, you're going too fast past South Florida because, you know, last year y'all needed a thunderstorm to win that game.
I agree. But they also have Jalen Milroe this year, so I think they'll get that one too. At Wisconsin, let's just go to the ones that I think are going to really, really determine a lot. At home versus Georgia.
Loss.
Georgia will probably be the favorite, depending on how they perform at Wisconsin.
And you know why I say that, Roman?
Why?
And I'm going to tell you why I say that.
Why?
Kirby, when that game comes up this year, Kirby will show you how different of a coach he is versus Nick Saban, and how he'll be a better coach not coaching Nick Saban versus Alabama. You just watch the difference in his coaching this year.
Okay. I can't wait. I literally can't wait to see this game. We get Georgia, Alabama in the regular season. We don't have to wait till the end of the year. Down the line, it's at Tennessee. Let me tell you something. This young man, Nico, and I'm not even going to try and mess up his last name because I ain't got that good at it yet. But the young man playing quarterback at Tennessee, Nico, he could be a total difference maker for this Tennessee offense this year. I think at Tennessee, you better watch out. Also, coming off of that, in another 7 days, you get Missouri at home. Missouri's a much more confident team than I've seen them under where they're at right now. So under Eli Drinkwitz as the head coach. And they bring back the quarterback. They bring back some other really good players on that offensive side. They do lose a lot on defense, but you got to be careful with the Missouri game as well. At LSU and at Oklahoma late in the year. I don't even know if guys in Alabama are used to playing in cold weather. It's going to be cold in Oklahoma and Norman. You better believe it in November 23rd. So those are the games I'm telling you right now, JK. Alabama could lose a couple games. I don't know. I don't know how they're going to react at the first time that Alabama may take a loss under Kalen DeBoer. But I will tell you this, JK, just to push back on you, and I want your opinion. What if Alabama beats Georgia?
They can beat Georgia. But my prediction for their season is 9-3 at best, 8-4 at worst. And you got to go along with at Tennessee, at LSU, at Oklahoma, and then you got to play Auburn, not to mention Georgia and Wisconsin. Come on, man. It's not going to be what the Bama fans think, but, hey, I've been wrong before. I may be wrong again. And let me tell all these Alabama fans something that's jumping up and down about Alabama Week 16. Reverse 1 year. Number one overall seed. Couldn't get past Sweet 16. Now here they are in the Sweet 16 versus North Carolina. Mm-hmm. I personally think Alabama is going to beat North Carolina.
Really?
But as far as, yeah. Okay. Because I'm going to tell you why. And I heard you talking about the big man for North Carolina. I don't trust him. That guy plays soft at times. He has an average game most of the time. So I think Alabama can beat him as long as Alabama's hitting the threes. If they're not hitting the threes, it'll be back to T-Town. But Sears, I heard a lot of people talking in my sports group that Sears is not going to be an NBA player, and they must be drunk and out of their mind because Sears is a dog. I hadn't seen a better guard for Alabama in the past at least 6-7 years. Not a point guard.
JK, I won't argue with that, man. Mark is a very talented guy, left-handed. He has developed so much, though. He's gotten so much better in the last couple years, just watching him develop his game from where he started out to where he is right now. Last year, he was just a complimentary piece to Brandon Miller. And this year, he's a flat-out scorer, played great defense this past week and helped lift them to the Sweet 16. And you're right. If Alabama's hitting three-pointers, they can beat anybody in the country. It's all about when they're not making those threes. How do they defend, which they don't do well all the time, but how do they lock in, defend, and rebound?
Hey, you know something else, man?
What's that?
That other team in the SEC that messed my bracket up first week, and I had them winning it all because of how they were playing the last five or six games. Kyle Apari, it's time for you to call two men in a truck and be on your way. Because there's no way you should get embarrassed like that again in the NCAA tournament. It doesn't make sense. All that talent, and you're out in the first game? No, man, it don't make sense. But, well, Roman, you have a good one, baby.
Hey, JK, appreciate it, baby. Thank you, man. Appreciate you, man. I'm ready for the smoke today. And, JK, you're correct. You're correct. You're not the only Kentucky fan a little sad, feeling a little bit blue today after that disappointing first round, man. We're going to get to a break right here. Coming up next, more of your calls. And we got a couple more guests coming up, too. We'll see you later. Not later.
Dog parents are loving Dr. Marty's Nature's Blend premium dog food.
The way she acts and the way she moves, it's just so much better. And she acts like she's like a puppy again. It's unbelievable.
Dr. Marty's Nature's Blend is a freeze-dried raw food made with zero artificial preservatives, so it's naturally shelf-stable with no mess, freezer, or fridge required. Plus, it's full of premium turkey, beef, salmon, and meat your dog will love.
We started with Nature's Blend. She's happy. She sleeps well. She's energetic. I am just delighted with this product.
When given the choice, Nature's Blend and Amazon's number one bestseller in dry dog food, 29 out of 30 dogs chose Nature's Blend first.
I am so confident your dog will love it. Your order is backed with a 90-day guarantee.
Save up to 54% off Nature's Blend and get a free bag of delicious beef liver treats. Go to drmartypets.com/turkey or text turkey to 511-511. Text turkey to 511-511.
All pets are unique. Your pet's results can and will vary. Message and data rates may apply. Studies available upon request.
This hour of the Paul Feinbaum Show is brought to you by the Huntsville International Airport and Breeze Airways.
The company is Eagle Masonry and Insulation, but did you know they're also Eagle Landscaping and Dirtwork? Eagle can take care of all your landscaping needs, including irrigation, sod work, and planting, both plants and trees. On the dirt work side, Eagle can grade and build your pads, haul dirt in or out, and even do erosion control. Philip Love and his team can do it all for you. The website is the same, insulatewitheagle.com, as is the phone number, 256-755-1556. Give them a call and see what Eagle can do for you. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
Hi, this is Wes Neighbors. I'm here with Sam Fleming with Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Sam, tell the folks about Fleming Roofing and Restoration.
Hey, Wes. Our company, Fleming Roofing and Restoration, specializes in commercial and residential roofing and repairs. I'm a fifth-generation Huntsvillian, and our family's been doing construction business in Huntsville area since 1965.
Sam, what kind of roofs does Fleming Roofing and Restoration do?
Our guys are skilled enough, we can come out and address any kind of leaks or issues you might have on your commercial, on your metal roofing, on your shingles. We can do anything, and we can offer you a solution to repair it, or we can replace it.
But you guys also do insurance restoration.
Our staff has 10-plus years of experience as insurance adjusters, and we really do know the inside and out of the claims process at Fleming Roofing and Restoration.
Check out Fleming Roofing and Restoration online at FlemingHSV.com, or you can call or text them at 256-651-9440.
Hey, Wes, we show up.
Did you know that Valley Equipment Rental also specializes in day and weekend rentals to homeowners? The weekend rentals is by far the best deal that they offer. If you pick up after 2 on a Friday or anytime Saturday morning, it's not due in until Monday morning before 8 a.m. for a one-day charge. For a small fee, Valley can even haul anything they carry. Valley has extremely experienced and knowledgeable staff that can help you decide what size machine you need or what type of machine you need to get your job done like a pro. They have all the big items that the contractor need for their jobs, but they also carry the small tools that can help you with your DIY project. More importantly, Valley is locally owned and operated, which means when you have an issue, you can get someone on it right away right here in the Valley. Heck, ask for Ross Roberts, the owner, if you like. Try calling one of the big box national outlets and ask for the owner. That's if you can even get through the automation. Buy local. Buy Valley Equipment Rental. Valley Equipment Rental has 2 locations, one on the North and South Parkway. Learn more at valleyequipmentrents.com.
This is Brent Musburger's VSiN Action Update on 97.7 ESPN The Zone. Unlike other credit cards that decline sports betting transactions or treat them as a cash advance, the GBank Visa Signature Card can load directly to your favorite sportsbook apps. G.bank/VSiN.
Men's Hoops Sweet 16 on Friday. South Region second seed Marquette by 6.5 against 11th seed NC State. Top seed Purdue favored by 4.5 against 5th seed Gonzaga in the Midwest Regional. Houston.